Adams Jr. to the mix, coming over from Eastern Washington, the club that just happens to be in the building this evening.
Well, Big Play VA is making college football history tonight at Autzen Stadium. Now, we all know about what he did at Eastern Washington, completely dominant performer. But he's done what no one else has done. He decided to prove to himself, prove to NFL scouts, prove to Oregon Duck fans that he's what has what it takes to play ball. He showed up in practice five, won the job in 2 weeks, and yes, we know him for his ability. He's done it against UW. He did it against Oregon State. But this young man, after talking to him yesterday, he simply oozes with swag. I mean, he's got dude qualities for days. When you look at his comparison against Jeff Locke, who was the front runner in training camp, you just got to look to the experience, the amount of snaps that Vernon Adams has played. He is ready for this, and I think he's going to have an incredible career here.
10,000 passing yards, Yogi. Goodness gracious, 110 TDs in the win-loss record. You can't argue with that. 28-6. Scott Frost is the offensive coordinator here in Oregon, and the one bit of advice he gave to Vernon Adams was, don't try to be other guys, help you out.
Well, I think this team is loaded. I think they have more depth. They're the healthiest they've been in the Mark Helfrich era, and a huge reason why is Rolls-Royce. Royce Freeman, he was Pac-12 Freshman of the Year on offense, an absolute dominant running back in between the tackles. And while this team was lauded because of Marcus Mariota and all the flash and all the sizzle, this is a downhill running attack, and it starts with number 21. He's going to get a heavy dose of the rock tonight.
Freeman, first team, Pac-12, led the Pac-12 in touchdown, scored 230 pounds. He is not a luxury automobile. He is a bullet train. And look who he's got alongside, Byron Marshall. They can put him out on the wing to receive the football or run it, Yogi.
Well, really dominant performer. Former running back, now playing wide receiver. Love this combination, putting a lot of stress on the defense of Eastern Washington.
Eastern Washington in the building to take on the Oregon Ducks, who have won 10 consecutive home openers, averaging 55 points in doing so. We've got the kickoff coming your way next, right here on the Pac-12 Network. Welcome back to Eugene, Oregon, set for football this afternoon. A 5 o'clock start here in Eugene. The number 7 Oregon Ducks to take on the Eastern Washington Eagles, who are ranked in the top 10 of the FCS as well. They've built quite a program there in Cheney, Washington. But a huge assignment today against the Oregon Ducks. With more on Eastern Washington, Lewis Johnson joins us.
Well, Kevin, if you're an underdog coming into a hostile environment like this stadium, you better have somebody in your team that can not only bring it on the field, but can also be that glue guy to keep everybody together and believing no matter what happens when you're in that bench area. And for Eastern Washington, Cooper Kupp is that guy. Kupp told us that they've played in many hostile stadiums before, and playing with a bit of a chip on your shoulder can be a good thing on a day like today. He said, we all know that adversity is going to happen in the football game. That's part of the deal. But coaches have already instilled in them to rise above that adversity. And the most important thing is get out of that victim mentality right away. It was Bo Baldwin who said that he'll need Kupp to make a lot of plays on the field today here at Autzen, but also keep people in the right frame of mind, composed, no matter what the game situation is. Kevin?
Thank you, Lewis. And of course, Yogi, the mantle now rests at the quarterback position to a gentleman who had some opportunities last year in Jordan West, the junior from Maple Valley, Washington, but up against Mark Helfrich, who's now in his third year, coming off a season when they won 13 games, including the march to the national championship, eventually won by Ohio State. They had it all rolling for him last year, but wow, trying to replace a Heisman Trophy winner and the best player to come down the pike here at Oregon, that's a tall order. We'll find out as that story is about to unfold here this afternoon.
Well, it's been 266 days since that game against Ohio State in the national championship. These players are excited to get back in front of their fans.
Eastern Washington will kick to the Oregon Ducks. Braylon Addison, after a year's absence because of a knee injury, is back along with Byron Marshall. And the ball is chipped toward the goal line, and it is taken by Byron Marshall. He comes right up the seam. He's at the 30. Makes a little wiggle out to the 35, and that's where the Oregon Ducks will go to work, just past their own 35-yard line. 36-yard return. And here is Vernon Adams using his last season of eligibility, completing his courses at Eastern Washington, and then able to transfer to Oregon with that one more year of eligibility.
We had a chance to talk to him yesterday, and he said, you know, I don't know how I'm going to feel. Some days I block it out. Some days I'm real emotional. We're going to find out early on how he handles his emotions going up against his former squad.
Adams with two men in the backfield. He'll open up with a run off to the left side, and that's Royce Freeman. Freeman, 230 pounds. He packs a punch when he hits that line. Of course, Oregon wants to get off a play about every 11 seconds or so, and so you will see rapid action here this afternoon. Adams on second down, throws off to the flank, and they'll throw to the tight end a great deal. That's Evan Bayless with the catch.
Well, that's going to be the thing to watch all evening long. How does Vernon Adams handle the tempo? Marcus Mariota, he was a freak, one of the best players in the history of the Pac-12 Conference, but he had mastery of this system. This is where Vernon Adams needs to grow.
Adams is back. He is flushed. He will work to his left. He leans to the 50. He's out to the far boundary, and he's across for first down and into Eastern Washington territory. Evan Bayless with a nice block downfield to Springham.
You can only laugh. And when we went back and watched Vernon Adams' games last year at Eastern Washington, then you talk to some of the coaching staff, they said he just has uncanny ability when things break down to find little seams, find little gaps. He thrives when it's a broken play.
How about the tempo of Oregon? Is it dissimilar at all from Eastern Washington? The throw to the far side. Man coming free out of the backfield again. It is Royce Freeman.
Well, what you love so far is Vernon Adams is his full command. He knows where his reads are. He's gotten to his second read already early on. We'll see if he has to get to his third, but just taking what the defense gives him, and here you go, a couple first downs, and they're knocking on the door.
Eastern Washington last year under Adams averaged 44 points a ball game. That was number one in the country. The misdirect, and again, they go to Royce Freeman. Mitch Fettig came up to make the stop. The freshman from Olympia, Washington, playing the free safety position.
Royce Freeman, he's such a big man. You know, you just put your arm on his shoulder and they call him like a Greek god. He's such a statuesque young man, only a sophomore, but he is fleet of foot. I mean, he can make defenders miss in space. Really dynamic athlete.
Dwayne Stanford is flanked out here to the near side. Two receivers to the left of Adams. Fakes a handoff, stumbles. Has a man breaking free out of the backfield. And it's going to go for a big game. Tumbling across the 10-yard line is Kanai Benoit, 210-pound redshirt sophomore out of Phoenix, Arizona, and he can fly.
And they love what he did in camp. They were seeking that back. Remember, Thomas Tyner out for the season. He was kind of that co-starter running back a year ago in their national championship run.
Gain at 43 on a play. Here's the handoff. Touchdown, played in a half dozen games last year, and you can bet he's going to get more work this year.
If you had to script, and I'm sure Vernon Adams laid in bed many times and just imagined that first drive here in Autzen Stadium, this was perfect. He managed the offense. Once the defense has to worry about if he's going to run the football or not, all of a sudden you create seams and gaps, and Benoit just finds the end zone. This is a team that just continues to reload at the skill positions.
Well, this is something the Ducks will do a great deal of. Jeff Lockheed, the quarterback, they're going to go for 2 points, and they won't get it as Eastern Washington swarms and stops the Oregon Ducks. 6-0 Oregon just underway here at Autzen Stadium. Vernon Adams and the Oregon Ducks leading Eastern Washington 6-0. This drive summary presented by 76. Take a look, 7 plays, 63 yards. Time of possession, 2 minutes and 17 seconds. And Vernon Adams opens up 3 for 3 and rushes for 10 yards himself. Kanai Benoit gets into the end zone for the touchdown from 8 yards in, out.
A great poise. I mean, think about how excited he must be to play. And he looked like the fifth year senior that he is in Vernon Adams.
Matt Wogan, the junior from Indian Trail, North Carolina, getting ready to get into the ball here. Shaq Hill, Simba Webster are back for Eastern Washington. Fair catch, touchback. And Eastern Washington will go to work at their own 25-yard line. Look at Jordan West. Stands 6'4 and did have some opportunities last year. Had the 9 touchdowns and 1 interception.
Yeah, went 3-1 last year. Filled in when Vernon Adams was injured. And had a chance to go to Cheney, watch him practice about a week and a half ago. And this is a big guy. I mean, all 6'4, 220. He looks the part as a Pac-12 quarterback. And he's excited, really, for this opportunity. And these receivers, they're Pac-12 caliber wideouts. So he's going to be able to deal today. The question will be, can he get the ball off in time, and can his wideouts beat this young secondary of Oregon?
Jabari Wilson is the primary back in the backfield. Keep an eye on Cooper Kupp, number 10, the junior, has 167 receptions already in his young career, sixth best in school history. On first down, they go to the middle, and up they come with a couple of yards on the play.
Now this offense is a variety of tempos. Sometimes they'll huddle, sometimes they won't. Really intricate offense. A lot is going to be on Jordan West. He's going to have to understand all the different defensive alignments that Don Pell, the defensive coordinator, will throw at him.
West turns and rifles a pass over the middle, complete, and very close to a first down. Shaq Hill with the reception on the play. Pick up of 8, and that will move the chains and a first down for Eastern Washington.
This offensive line for Eastern Washington, they think it's a strength. 82 starts combined with all the guys up front.
Kendrick Bourne, 1 of 3, flanked to the right of West. He'll hand off on first down.
So much about this game, as we talked about Vernon Adams, and obviously it's deservingly so. But keep in mind, Eastern Washington, all these kids are from this region for the most part. They all wanted to play here at Oregon, and they got their opportunity to prove that they should have been offered.
West a walk-on, but he arrived at Eastern Washington. Throwing an inside screen, Simba Webster makes the reception, but Chris Cisse comes up to make the stop.
Talk to the Oregon staff, and they are absolutely in love with Chris Cisse. Big time potential, played a year ago as a freshman, started in the Rose Bowl and the national championship game.
Three starters of a year ago from the back four have departed, but they do have some youth that got some experience last year because of injuries and so forth. Back to pass is West. Dirty pocket, has to run. Nearly had his head taken off near the 40-yard line. Down by Johnny Reagan.
The speed of Oregon is just different. It's different than Eastern Washington. It's different than the majority of teams in the Pac-12 Conference. Things break down. A lot of quarterbacks here, they're getting the first. But the backers, the safeties, everybody can fly to the football. Johnny Reagan leading the charge, playing that nickel position.
Jordan Descalo, the sophomore from Taft High School in Los Angeles, to punt. Raylan Addison is back. Flutter down to the Oregon 28-yard line, and that's where they will go back to work, leading 6-0 here early from Monson Stadium. Well, let's take a look now at our Reese's Perfect Combination.
Well, it's going to really be up front. Matt Hegarty, he's another transfer. We don't get a lot, doesn't get as much love as Vernon Adams, but transfer from Notre Dame. His story is incredible. Came to camp here in high school, is out of New Mexico, was really excited. It kind of came down to Notre Dame and Oregon, didn't work out, went to the Fighting Irish, and then had the ability to transfer. They were going to play him in a variety of different positions on the offensive line. He thought this was best for his future, and he made the transition. He showed up day one of camp and just fit in with that offensive line group, and that's not an easy group to fit in with.
He and Vernon Adams had a whole lot to learn. Here's a pass slanting to the near side. That for a first down. Byron Marshall made himself available. The senior from San Jose, California, has rushed for over 1,000 yards and has caught over 1,000 yards as well in his storied career here at Oregon. On first down, Vernon Adams drops back, throws, tight spiral, and extending out, but incomplete. Down there was Braylon Addison after it.
You know, an interesting element of Vernon Adams' game.
And welcome into Autzen Stadium here in Eugene, Oregon. Oregon on top 6-0. We welcome the crowd that is watching California and Grambling here to the brilliant sunshine in Oregon. Braylon Addison scoots off to the far side. Already Oregon has scored with a youngster, Kenai Benoit, scoring from 8 yards out. Flanker screen to Dwayne Stanford, and he's rolled out of bounds at the near boundary. Inside Eastern Washington territory, that's a first down.
They think this receiving core is as deep as they've ever been, whether it was Chip Kelly or Mark Helfrich as the head coach, and Dwayne Stanford's a big reason why. Started 13 games a year ago, was absolutely dominant in training camp. This is a big guy, 6'5", 205. His nickname's Too Tall. And he, every day, he battled Tyree Robinson. He really has grown regarding all the intricacies of the receiver position. Expect him to have a big year.
First down for Oregon. Don't blink. Here they come. Royce Freeman surveys, works to the far side, chops his steps, and gets across for another first down.
Keep an eye on Big 64, Tyler Johnstone. He's coming back. He hasn't played in a little while. Had a big injury. It's good to get him at that left tackle position. One of their most gifted offensive linemen.
Cameron Hunt and Matt Pearson, the guards. And Terrell Crosby playing the right tackle. He got some experience last year because of injuries up front. Again, they go to the rear post. Royce Freeman breaks a couple of tackles and then is finally pushed out of bounds. And he gains another first down for the Ducks.
Can you imagine having to tackle him one-on-one?
No, I can't.
I mean, you cannot arm tackle Royce Freeman. Doesn't matter who you are, whether you're Scooby Wright, the top defensive player in the country, or you're playing for Eastern Washington. I mean, he is a load, all 230 pounds, of him, and he's got sneaky speed.
Vernon Adams will turn, and the handoff. Tonight, Ben Wall will get it. And he's across the Eastern Washington 15-yard line.
Vernon Adams, remember, he was trained as a pocket passer. When he came out of high school, out of Pasadena, a chance to talk to his high school coach earlier today, Dean Harrington.
Adams fakes the handoff to Keith. His cutback spins and is hauled down shy of the 5-yard line.
But that's where he was trained, even when he went to Eastern Washington or Bo Baldwin. There's so much that the quarterback has to do with the line of scrimmage. So operating the Oregon offense now, with his background of functional football intelligence, is going to allow him to play really fast because he's just going to recognize things. He can understand coverages. Of course, he's going to understand the defense he's going up against because he went against it for 4 years.
Alec catch marching, caught up to him. Adams rolls into the end zone. Touchdown, Braylon Addison with a reception from Vernon Adams. And Oregon on top, 12-0 here early.
Congratulations to Vernon Adams for his first career touchdown pass at Oregon, but really Braylon Addison, what an incredible story. This young man missed last year after a knee injury, came back, was so excited to get going, got the start today.
Aiden Schneider to kick. And movement up front.
False start. Offense, number 57, 5-yard penalty, try for point.
Well, that'll make things more interesting. Will the Ducks go for two here? Nope, they're going to go ahead and kick. Snyder backed up to the 15-yard line. Ducks score again, quickly. This time, Vernon Adams rolling to his left and throwing deep in the end zone to Addison, 13-0, Oregon. Time now for the Cold Hard Facts presented by Coors Light.
Well, they tie another game with a touchdown pass here. Ties the NCAA record. Vernon Adams, safe to say, well, it'll be fun to see next week. They go to Michigan State, see if they could break that record. The way the offense is looking thus far, I'd say that's a strong likelihood.
The prediction from Yogi Roth so early in the ballgame is interesting. He would go that direction. Touchback, Eastern Washington bring it out to the 25-yard line. Keys to the game brought to you by La Quinta. Take a look at the La Quinta keys to the game.
Well, for Eastern Washington, you want to attack the Oregon secondary. You just hope you have enough time to do it. And for Oregon defensively, follow their seniors. I mean, this is an almost all senior laden front seven. When you really study this team and you dive into them, you forget that, wow, they got some guys up front. DeForest Buckner, not only him, but you can go up and down the roster. Rodney Harwood, Joe Walker, Tyson Coleman, a lot of guys who have played a lot of football on the defensive side. And when you look at teams who have won championships in the Pac-12, the teams that have stopped the run and created turnovers, they've been doing that here for a really long time.
Eastern Washington comes out on first down. They empty out the backfield. In the gun is Jordan West, the junior. Backs and throws to the near wing, and Cooper Kupp with the reception. Kupp already sixth all-time in the school record books in receptions, and he has a first down.
He's gone off every time they've played a big-time opponent over the last 2 years, whether it was Oregon State 2 years ago or UW a year ago. Last year, 8 grabs for 145 yards and 3 touchdowns. So he loves these stages.
Eagles go to the ground. Cisse comes up to make the stop. Brings up second down and 8. West flings it out to the far boundary. Missed tackle. And a gain. But stepping out of bounds off to the far side. Nick Splendorio, the sophomore.
Trying to work the sideline a little bit. Might be the hair short here.
Third and 1. Splendorio, the intended receiver. But closing on him fast was Chris Cisse.
I think you got to go for it here. I mean, that's a miss by Jordan West. You got to complete that. That's easy. They're going to go for it because look what's happening. This Oregon offense is going to go. Eastern Washington's defense, they struggled last year. New defensive coordinator now. But still, you don't want to give them the ball back down 2 scores.
Fourth and 1. Wilson, the man in motion, now flanked. They empty it out. West going for a quick little in route, and the pass complete to Shaq Hill. Hill, the senior from Stockton, California. Second team Big Sky a year ago.
Well, if Oregon's going to play one-on-one coverage on the outside and critical downs and distances, it's actually an advantage for Eastern Washington. Cooper Kupp, Shaq Hill, Kendrick Bourne, those 3 receivers, they can win those matchups.
Eastern the first down. Movement. Chris Cisse may have been across the line of scrimmage early, coming in from the corner. Referee Land Clark.
Offside. Defense number 12. A 5-yard penalty. Replay. First down.
You know, Bo Baldwin, he's going to take some risks in this game. He does it all the time in their conference games as well. He's as good of a coach as you're going to find. Really unique offensive mind. He's had success everywhere he has gone. They have a good game plan. Can they execute against a more athletic Oregon defense?
First and 5. Pump fake West. Little double move. Throws to the far sideline. And that ball is caught. Outstanding catch off to the far side. Coming down with it was Kendrick Bourne, the junior from right here in Portland, Oregon.
Well, it's man-to-man coverage against sophomore Aaron Springs. It's a slant and go. And Bourne, he's dynamic when the ball's in the air. He did it all last year when you watch him on film. Did it early on in this ballgame.
Just up the road to Portland, Oregon. Back to throw is West. Looking to the post. Touchdown, Eastern Washington University. Shaq Hill hauls it in on a beautiful touch pass from Jordan West. This is a team that scored 44 points a game last year. But with Vernon Adams at the controls. But don't discount Jordan West's abilities.
No, and don't discount his wide receivers. Shaq Hill, he's as veteran, as savvy as a wideout. He did a nice job utilizing his hands there to catch a touchdown.
Tyler McNanny on to add the extra point. And the kick is up and good. And Eastern Washington on the board, trailing Oregon 13-7. Jordan West looks right up into the brilliant sunshine. And a terrific catch hauled in by Shaq Hill. Well, after the Ducks score unanswered, Eastern Washington comes right back with a touchdown of their own as Jordan West links up with Shaq Hill.
Going for it on fourth down pays off for Bo Baldwin and his team.
short kick flutters to one of the up men, and he secures it. And Oregon goes to work. Take a look back at that touchdown a moment ago.
Well, Shaq Hill, he's a veteran receiver. He's going to do a nice job of utilizing his hands before the official's going to look at him. You'll see it. We'll freeze it. Look at his hands right there. He kind of gives a little push off, a little nudge against Cisse. The ref isn't looking there. The ref, you see his eyes? Refs are trained to see the ball, and then you go at the end where the receiver's about to catch it. That's a veteran move. Utilize your hands a little early. You get that quick little early push off. You use your wing, your elbow. Pushes a tad bit. That allows him to free up and touch and catch a touchdown.
Vernon Adams out of Pasadena, California on first down. We'll give it over to Royce Freeman. Tries to cut back. Got caught up in the clutter. And a gain of a couple on the play. Todd Raines, the co-captain of Eastern Washington, comes up to make the stop. He's a senior from Kenmore, Washington. First couple of possessions. The Ducks go seven plays, 63 yards and a touchdown. Benoit scores on the ground. They summon Royce Freeman. He's across midfield.
When you play defensive football against this type of offense, it's usually a gap sound defense, meaning I have my area. And if one defender overruns their area, all of a sudden you can run a truck through that hole. And that's exactly what happened for Freeman.
Freeman, six carries, 51 yards already. Vernon Adams checks right, throws left up the seam, has a man back. And just down to the 2 yard line comes the long, rangy tight end, Dwayne Stanford, the wideout from Cincinnati, Ohio.
Watch Vernon Adams from one to two, all the way across the field to number three. That's somebody who's got a little mastery of this system.
And they send Royce Freeman into the end zone, touchdown Oregon. They always talk about sudden change here in Oregon. They're scored upon, then they come right back with a burst. They run it right down Eastern Washington's throat with Royce Freeman. The catch by Stanford, and then back to the ground they go.
Look, we don't want to start comparing Vernon Adams to Marcus Mariota, but on that drive and that sequence of plays, that's exactly what we've seen Marcus Mariota do in this stadium for years. Run, quarterback run, easy throws, and all of a sudden you get to the third person in your progression, touchdown, and all of a sudden we get moving, and this is what this offense does.
Aiden Schneider to add the extra point now for the Ducks. And it's 20-7 Oregon with 4:23 left in the first. Royce Freeman not even breaking a sweat. Neither is Vernon Adams, as a matter of fact.
Well, this team's always had a unique focus. I don't think Mark Helfrich has gotten enough credit being the head coach here and really doing a nice job making this team focus, snap in and snap out. And I'll tell you what, Vernon Adams, you couldn't have written a better script to start this thing off. He stayed in the pocket. He's trusted his reads. He's gotten to his backside of the backfield. He's gotten to the third guy in his progression. He's utilized his God-given ability, which is the ability to run or also keep his eyes downfield. And Eastern Washington fans watching, they've seen that for years. And this young man, he's coming into his own. He understands a sense of urgency. This being his last year, he won the job. He's won over his teammates. But nothing can solidify you as the guy outside of playing well. And he's done that thus far in this game.
I just wonder how much the offense Scott Frost has installed. What percentage of that offense has he actually been able to translate to Vernon Adams? Here's the kickoff. Deep into the end zone. A bit of hesitation. Simba Webster will bring it out. He is spun around. The ball nearly taken out of his grasp. So Eastern Washington goes to work deep in their own end at the 12-yard line.
And we talked to Scott Frost about that. Of how much did you really give Vernon Adams? And he showed up day five of practice. That means they're in their fifth day of install. They can't slow down everything just to make sure number three can get caught up. So he had to really cram on his own, cram with Scott Frost late at night, early in the mornings, and he did so. And then when you get into game week, you get to pare back a lot. You just put in the 60 or so plays of your scheme. And remember, with this Oregon offense, it's about 20 concepts. They just dress them up a lot differently with different formations, personnels, and things of that nature. So I think when you give him the limited playbook, he can fly. And I think his playbook is only going to grow as the season goes on.
West on first down, trying to get a little room out there. We'll go off left tackle. Gain of five on the play. Jalen Moore going to work, the junior from La Puente, California.
We've seen Oregon put in fresh bodies. Every time Bo Baldwin brings a new personnel in, so does Oregon. They want to rotate 25 players with their starting unit on defense.
Second and five. West screen pass near side. And again, they call on Jalen Moore.
Joe Walker, he is a big guy, 6'2", 240, returning starter, probably their most consistent defensive player.
First down for Eastern Washington. West fakes the handoff, lets it develop. And a completion made by Zach Wimberly.
We were at practice about a week and a half ago, and Eastern Washington, they weren't intimidated by this environment. They expected to win. They expect to move the football. Having some success last drive and now this drive.
West fakes the handoff, rolls out right. Connor Cup with a reception, but shoved out of bounds. Arian Springs comes over to make the tackle. Brings a sophomore from San Antonio, Texas.
They said he had the biggest breakout camp. Weren't really sure about his ability. Really confident young man. You have to be at the corner position. But they said he played incredibly well in training camp. Really earned that starting spot.
Brings up second and 7. There to go that time as Jabari Wilson is swarmed under. Tui Talia up front makes the stop, 6'5 senior out of Concord, California. Third and 7 now for Eastern Washington. Let's see what they dial up.
Keep an eye on Christian French in the bottom of your screen as a defensive end off the edge.
Horton will bring 4. West got hit. West unloads. Pass incomplete. And it brings up 4th down for Eastern.
Look at what Oregon does up front. They do a nice job. It's called a twist. The defensive tackle goes outside. Christian French, he loops back inside. It happens on the opposite side as well. When you're moving so many different players, it becomes really hard as Tyson Coleman got himself into the backfield.
Jordan Descalo to punt. Braylon Addison is back, waiting at his 16-yard line. Addison will fair catch, and Oregon will go to work at their own 23-yard line, leading 20-7 with a minute 38 left here in this first quarter of play. Vernon Adams has fit in seamlessly, it seems, with Oregon here in this first quarter of play. Royce Freeman is in the same kind of shape he was in at the end of the year when he was just destroying teams.
They really do a nice job in their offseason workouts and then their training camp. When they're at practice, they fly. They go as many plays as possible. They believe in coaching off the film in the meeting. They don't do a lot of coaching on the field, so they can get their players in shape.
Addison, the man in motion. Nice tackle there, but fighting through the first contact and then plowing ahead. Is Benoit.
Well, there's a real competition for this backup running back spot. They're going to figure it out early on in this season. They've got Benoit, Tony Brooks James.
They go to Byron Marshall this time. He bounces outside.
I mean, think of the weapons. I mean, this offense, remember a year ago when they played in the national championship game, they were banged up. Carrington didn't play. They lost a lot of guys, obviously, up front as the season went on. Devin Allen was injured early on in that ball game. So this is as healthy as they've been at the skill positions.
Good pass. Here is Kenai Benoit breaking it up to the far sideline and driven out of bounds. Big game for Benoit, who already has a touchdown this afternoon.
Look at that hole. How about that? Then he'll just follow the block of Byron Marshall. Nice job of these young backs and their vision setting up their blocks.
First and 10. Adams is back on tiptoe. Slings one down the seam, and that one sails over the head of the intended receiver, Braylon Addison.
When you look back at Vernon Adams Jr.'s film in his career at Eastern Washington, one area where he's going to continue to grow is completing passes in between the hashes. And that's hard. He's not the biggest of guys. Trained as a more of a pro-style guy than one might think. But that's an area when he goes up against Pac-12 conference opponents, they're going to force him to complete those balls.
Well, just an embarrassment of riches as Tony Brooks James comes into the lineup, the freshman from Gainesville, Florida. It scoots here to the near side. So it's Freeman, Benoit, and now Tony Brooks James with the carry. And movement up front by the Oregon Ducks as they go back to work on first down.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense number 72, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Well, Brooks James was a big-time recruit, and they said he has big play potential. He did it all training camp, and he's earned the playing time now. And yeah, sitting on the sideline watching Benoit make some plays, now he said, hey, it's my turn.
Brooks James stays in the backfield. He'll take it. He tries to cut it up off the left tackle. It gets across the 20-yard line. It's spun around by Todd Raines. That'll end the first quarter of play with the Oregon Ducks, led by Vernon Adams, leading 20-7 at the end of the first here on the Pac-12 Network. The Oregon Ducks out on top of the Eastern Washington Eagles 20-7 as we get set now for the second quarter play. 26 plays run by the Oregon Ducks, 258 total yards, Yogi, in time of possession under 8 minutes so far.
And they probably want to go faster. You know, great efficiency thus far, and Vernon Adams, great command. Really like how Scott Frost has called this game.
Vernon Adams will fake and will keep, and he plows across the 20-yard line. There's a man down for the Eagles, down near the line of scrimmage. We'll come right back and report on the progress of Zach Bruce, the player down on the field, in a moment.
And we are back in Eugene with the Ducks up 20-0 over Eastern Washington. And Bo Baldwin saying that he really wouldn't know what the speed is like until he experienced it. It's not just the speed, but it's how efficient the Ducks are with that speed. Well, the first three possessions in the first quarter, 2 minutes and 17 seconds, 2:42 and 58 seconds, resulting in three touchdowns. I've been watching these Eastern Washington defensive secondary coaches work with their guys, trying to help them slow down the Ducks, talking a lot about form tackling and wrapping everybody up. But it's a tough deal down here. And I can tell you, too, there's been a lot of work with the trainers working on guys like Mitch Fettig, who had his chin busted up. So these defensive secondary guys are really trying to hold down the Ducks, but it's a tough deal today.
And a moment ago, Zach Bruce walked under his own pad off the field. They give now to Tony Brooks James, who a moment ago came out of the backfield, broke a tackle, and squirmed for another couple of yards. And now he runs into the end zone. And youth will be served here at Oregon, the redshirt freshman from Gainesville, Florida.
And then they got a little town in the backfield. Whoa, they got some speed around sure the edge. I'll tell you what, Oregon is not lacking athleticism. They continue to recruit and reload. And these aren't huge recruits in terms of dominating other big-time schools. They're just getting guys that fit their system. What a great job of evaluating the high school talent in both of these young running backs we've seen thus far this evening.
Aiden Snyder will lead the extra point, and the Ducks lead it 27-7. Ducks with another scoring drive under 3 minutes. They are 4-4 in that category today. Yeah, the Oregon Ducks on the board again. The last five seasons, here's how they have ranked in the nation. They've led the Pac-12 in scoring since 07.
Absolutely dominant in terms of just moving the ball down the field, being efficient. And they've also led the nation in takeaways. I mean, they've been dominant in so many phases of this game.
The This ball will drive Shaq Hill back to the end zone. That's a touchback. Eastern Washington will take over. Let's go to San Francisco right now, though, for an update from Mike Yam.
All right, Kevin, time for your Transamerica game break. Texas A&M up 14-0 on ASU. Mike Berkovici to Cody Cole. It's a four-yard strike to the tight end. Remember, no Kalen Ballagin for the Sun Devils. He's sick. It's 14-7 at the break. Back to Kevin. Yogi Lewis.
Thank you, Mike. You know, we were talking during the break, Yogi, about the three-man front of the Oregon Ducks with Henry Mondo getting the start this afternoon, the sophomore from Portland, Oregon, Alex Balducci, the senior, and DeForest Buckner, senior from Hawaii, all bearing down on Jordan West. He goes to work here on first down. He'll fake a handoff. Throws out far side. Connor Cup with it. Breaks a tackle. Has a first down and more across the 40 to the 50. In a foot race. Here comes Cup. Down to the 20-yard line. Still on his feet. Still moving forward. Diving to the pylon. And apparently out of bounds at the 2-yard line.
You want to talk about willing yourself and trying to will your team back into this game. Watch Cooper Kupp. He's been dominant in his 2 years, picking up blocks from the receivers. Then he just says, you know what, this is on me. And this is just fighting and fighting, tooth and nail, using that weapon, that right arm. What a nice job going up against Aaron Springs. Cooper Kupp, we asked Coach Baldwin about him. He said, quote, he needs a big game and expects a huge game from him.
Jordan West quickly to the line of scrimmage at the 2-yard line of the Ducks. The turn and the handoff, and Wilson is stacked up at the 3-yard line.
Cooper Kupp, 37 touchdowns the last 2 years, has played huge in big games. At Oregon State 2 years ago, over 100 yards, two touchdowns. Against Washington last year, 145 yards receiving, three touchdowns. He loves these environments.
West will turn, and the handoff is to Jalen Moore, who noses forward just shy of the end zone.
Well, if I'm Bo Baldwin, this is four-down territory here. You're not taking a field goal, so you got two downs here. They love their offensive line. They think it's a strength for them. Look for them to run left over Clay DeBoer, their left tackle.
The handoff again comes to Jalen Moore. This time he is chopped down for maybe a loss of a yard on the play.
Tui Talia working his way into the rotation, played in all 15 games last year. Was a first-team junior college All-American, transferred in. He's a senior. A lot of depth up front. And if you're a defensive lineman, you love this. This is why you go through two-a-days. This is why you go to all those offseason workouts for fourth down inside the 2-yard line.
Alex Balducci lines up right over the ball. West in the pistol. He's going to roll out. West is going to throw. Touchdown, Eastern Washington. Making himself available at the post was Kendrick Bourne at the pylon to the near side. Bourne from Portland, Oregon.
Bourne's a savvy wide receiver. Runs a little in and out route. Beats the safety. Beats Chris Cisse. This receiving core is a Pac-12 caliber wide receiving core. Make no mistake about it. They remind me a little bit of Cal in terms of the diversity of their receivers. Bourne, big, lanky.
Well, team that averaged 44 points a game last year. Best in the nation. And a lot of the weapons still around. Vernon Adams obviously moving on here to Oregon. And the relationship there at Eastern Washington University. Yogi, how would you measure that at this point?
Well, they're best of friends. I mean, this summer, Cooper Kupp got married. Vernon Adams was there for him and Anna's wedding, in the wedding party. I mean, these are best of friends. Talking to both of them, they said they talked this week. It wasn't any joking around. It was serious. It was wishing each one of them best of luck. And this is a little bit awkward, but this is a little awkward between these two, but really high competitors. They both raised each other's games when they were both on the roster of Eastern Washington. And there's an element of Vernon Adams, I'm sure, that says, yep, I'm not surprised by that big playability by Cooper Kupp. And 104 grabs last year, most in FCS. just had his 200th career reception, and that was his longest career reception. I'm surprised he was passed over. Talked to a lot of coaches in the Pac-12 this last week, so how come he didn't recruit him? His dad, his grandfather played in the National Football League, has the bloodlines, but he was passed up, and he's making the most of it.
Jordan Descano ready to kick off. This is Marshall.
Well, this offense is at its best when it's really efficient. They've been extremely efficient thus far this evening. They've got to continue to be that way because they go so fast. And you've seen it in games where Oregon has lost over the last couple years, whether it was Stanford a couple years ago, Arizona last year. When they struggle on first down, because they go so fast, all of a sudden their defense is back on the field that they have to be, put themselves in the third and long. So I'm looking forward to watching the efficiency of Vernon Adams in Oregon.
Yeah, they want to re-kick. Offside penalty. There is Scott Frost, the offensive coordinator of the Oregon Ducks. A terrific dual threat quarterback in his days at Nebraska.
And he's in a really unique situation here. Remember, in his career, he followed up Tommy Frazier.
That's right.
And that was not an easy thing to do after they won a national championship. So he said he didn't really talk a lot to Vernon Adams about replacing Marcus Mariota. They touched upon it here and there. I'm sure as the season goes on, they'll talk about it. But not only is he a brilliant play caller, definitely an up-and-coming potential head coach in either next year or the year after that. It's going to happen quickly for Scott Frost, but he's got a lot of depth to him about this position, about dealing with adversity as he went through it as a player as well.
Mark Helfrich, he was awarded a new contract extension in the offseason, now in his third year, coming off 11 wins 2 years ago, 13 wins last year. Including a shot at a national championship, won by, of course, Ohio State. Descalo now will tee it up at the 30-yard line, and Braylon Addison, Byron Marshall getting set. Marshall is back. Marshall to run up on it. Has a block, has an opening. He's going to cut it back to the 40, tripped up. Spilled in there by a collision with his own man. Cole Karstetter came up to make the stop on Marshall.
Byron Marshall doesn't get the love I think that he deserves. Such a talented player. Last year playing wide receiver, over 1,000 yards. The year before as a running back, over 1,000 yards. And we talk about a lot of other players in this conference. He's in the same mold as the DJ Fosters, of the Adoree Jacksons. He's a dynamic playmaker, was a massive recruit here. He's lived up to the hype, and now he's the senior. He's the guy in the meeting rooms. He's really the leader of this offense.
Royce Freeman's back in the backfield now for Oregon. Vernon Adams on first down. Steps up, throws, nearly intercepted. Ball going right through the hands of the linebacker down there. Should have probably been a pick.
Well, the thing to remember, right, is this defense of Eastern Washington, they've gone up against Vernon Adams for years. So one of the keys for this game is for them trusting their instinct and just going, because they have some elements that are built into themselves, into their DNA, because they've just gone against him so much. Should have had a pick right there.
Samson Ebukam was under that ball, did not make the catch. So Oregon will go back to work on third down. Everyone brings up third down.
And this is where he's got to execute, these third downs.
Is caught by the tight end Evan Bayless, 6'6 junior from Centennial, Colorado.
Vernon Adams does a nice job. His feet are going one way, his hips are going one way, and he can still make that accurate pass out to the right to move the chains. That is not an easy throw. That's something you work on in the offseason.
Adams fakes the handoff, has a man deep, angling the pass. Down to the 10-yard line. Dwayne Stanford, big target at 6'5. Had a great year last year, 43 receptions, And 29 of them were for either a first down or a touchdown. He's a big play guy on third down.
Well, that's all on Stanford, too. He was thrown into double coverage. He just boxed out the two defenders and went up and got the ball like it was a rebound.
Adams back to throw, settles in, throws a bullet. That one intended for Stanford, but too tall.
Watch Dwayne Stanford. It's a post route. He just climbs right in front of the two defensive backs at Eastern Washington. Just puts his body in front of him, makes the grab, and that's hard. That's hard to defend. That's just pure athleticism and size.
Second and goal. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. Byron Marshall flanked to the right of Adams and to the near side. Comes Braylon Addison. Handoff comes to Freeman, tries to cut back and does, and plows ahead to the six. There's a flag on the play.
Personal foul, face mask, defense number 99. That penalty will be enforced half the distance of the goal with an automatic first down.
JT Teoli, the guilty party. And so Oregon goes back to work, and here's Freeman just dancing into the end zone. Touchdown, Oregon. And all that, Yogi, coming on that third down strike to Dwayne Stanford to set him up deep in Eastern Washington territory.
Well, defense of Eastern Washington, they're in the right spots. Everybody's in their right gaps, but it's just a foot race. And it doesn't really matter who you are. Boyce Freeman and you one-on-one, if you're an outside back or defensive end, he's going to beat you to the pylon.
Aiden Schneider on to add the extra point for the Ducks. And Oregon leads 34-14 with 10:37 left in the first half. More fireworks from Autzen Stadium still ahead here on the Pac-12 Network. Well, the Oregon Ducks last year had 78 scoring drives under 3 minutes. Today, Yogi, more of the same. 5 for 5 in drives under 3 minutes, and they've been very consistent, haven't they?
It's just who they are. It's their identity. And what it does is it gets the opposing team out of their rhythm, outside of their game plan, because points are just piling up.
Shaq Hill grabs this one, scoots right up the middle, has an opening. There's a flag and a play. The ball is ripped away from Hill. He's able to backtrack and cover it at the 40-yard line. Watch Matt Wogan, the kicker.
Tries to change the ball. Shaq Hill, and never want to do that when you're around contact, but.
During the return, holding, receiving team number 37. A 10-yard penalty, first down, Eastern Washington.
Bo Baldwin talked about it with us earlier this week, saying we got to steal a couple things. You know, we got to make some big plays, whether it's on special teams. That play obviously nullified, or Cooper Kupp on his long reception down inside the five. Got to keep making some of those, just because before you know it, Oregon gets another touchdown, another touchdown. I mean, you're watching this game, you wouldn't think they have 34 points. They just kind of happens.
Jordan West at the controls, 12 of 14, 173 yards, 2 touchdowns. He's had a pretty good afternoon. He steps back, looks, and the play blown dead.
False start. Offense number 79. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Now keep an eye on this hold. You'll see it. But the man that he's holding, Fotu Leato. This true freshman, what an interesting story. He was completely under-recruited out of the state of Washington. And all of a sudden, his highlight tape just kind of exploded, literally. He went from 20 looks to 20,000 looks to over 617,000 views on Huddle. Everyone around the country saw the way that he played, and it was with an intensity. It reminds you of Troy Polamalu. He's got the hair coming out, the dominant player on special teams playing early in his career.
Screen pass comes to the near side for Eastern Washington, but there is a flag on the play as Shaq Hill has run out of bounds. Coming up to get him was Tyree Robinson.
Offside. Defense number 44. That penalty's declined. The result of the play is the first down.
So both clubs getting a little twitchy out there right now. First down at the 32. West is back. Fires a bullet over the middle. Connor Cup with it, threading his way across the 40-yard line. Boy, he's so good after the catch with his head up. Quick burst of speed, taking angles away from guys.
You know, he's a real student of the game. Does a nice job getting past the linebackers.
Cooper Cup with a reception. And now West goes back to work here to the near side. Little screen pass is Eastern Washington now trying to find their offensive rhythm.
Well, they took advantage of tempo there. You don't see that happen very often to Oregon. Eastern Washington doesn't change personnel. Oregon tries to. They're late on in the field. They run the screen to the boundary, the bubble screen. Big game.
Second down and four for West. West throws it up for grabs. It's intercepted. Not sure where he was going with that one. Yogi seemed to be confused when he let it go. There wasn't a whole lot of conviction there as Chris Cisse plucks it out of midair. It was thrown right to him.
Well, Bo Baldwin's not happy, and I get it. They thought it was a free play. Looked as though the defensive line for Oregon jumped off sides. You're taught as a quarterback, it's a free play. Take a shot to your receiver. You'll see, yep, two guys. To me, that's a missed call, and as a quarterback, that's what you're supposed to do. You even yell it in practice when it happens. Free play, and you take a shot. Receiver kind of quit on the route, and he threw it up.
Prior to that, he had a pretty good afternoon going 15-17, 232 and two touchdowns, but Oregon will take it on the turnover, and Adams comes the other way. The ball's poked free from behind by him, from him, and it is recovered by Eastern Washington. Eastern Washington will have the football.
Now the ball's a little loose. And you know, in this Oregon program, that is the number one thing they talk about. For the last 5 years, the Oregon Ducks are plus 78. That's 40 more than anyone else in the Pac-12 conference. They're plus 78 in turnovers. It's ridiculous. Last year, best team in the country in terms of turnover differential. That is not okay for Vernon Adams to have the ball loose, as though sometimes it's going to get punched out, but high and tight is the number one priority if you're an Oregon Duck and you have the ball in your hands.
So West will get it right back. Fires to a man out of the backfield. Chris Cisse, he's been in on a lot of action this afternoon. He comes up and delivers a blow on Jalen Moore.
Well, this secondary, they've been hearing about it all offseason long, about all the players that they lost in the back end, from Troy Hill, Ifo Ekpre-Olumu, Eric Dargan. They want to prove they can play at this level, and this is their first opportunity.
Cisse getting his first starts in the Pac-12 championship and then in the championship game. West back to throw, trying to set up a screen, but boy, that is blown up. Jalen Moore is knocked down by T.J. Daniel, the defensive end.
They're going to rotate at least eight players up front. T.J. Daniel, one of them, out of Bishop O'Dowd High School in Oakland, California. Former tight end, redshirted a couple years ago, played in every game last year. And they can bring fresh bodies off the edge, and they have the depth to do it. Look out in situations like third down.
Third and 13. West to the far side. And the pass is caught, but shy of the first down is Cooper Cup, who's been a busy man this afternoon. Five catches for Cup and over 100 yards already today. Eastern Washington on fourth down will load up the backfield. That was Moore plowing ahead. Looks like he's got the needed yard for the first down.
Tell you what, when you just look down the line of scrimmage, Morgan's close to being offsides every snap. I mean, they're defensive linemen. They are close just to getting a call. Jalen Jenks at times, he's been really close to the line of scrimmage. Look at the defensive end. I mean, he looks like he's over the ball right now.
West hesitates, throws to the near pylon. Kupp is after it. And it is broken up. In coverage was Arion Springs, the sophomore from San Antonio, Texas, who played in 9 games last year as a freshman.
Look at their hands. See the black line? That's our line of scrimmage. Look at their hands. If I'm Bo Baldwin, I'm immediately going to these officials.
Second and 10. 7:01 to go in the second. Jordan West underthrows the intended receiver, Kendrick Bourne.
And West knows it. A little bit behind him. A lot of crossing routes in this offense, trying to get underneath these linebackers. Bourne creates some matchup issues. Tall, lanky receiver, really good ball skills, 6'3", 190. Probably their best guy when the ball's up in the air in a jump ball situation.
Third and 10. Eastern Washington 0-for-5 in third down situations. West is back to throw, zips a pass to Connor Kupp. He's across the 20, still on his feet, churning to the 15, and he's got a first down. Cooper Kupp.
He's dynamic. You know, some players, that, you know, the old adage is he's just a football player. He's a football player. May not be straight ahead fast, but this guy can do a little bit of everything. I mean, he's been an All-American since he was a redshirt freshman. And he's got a knack with the ball in his hands. He spins away from it, been around the game for a long time. Dad and grandfather both played in the National Football League.
6:27 to go, second quarter. Oregon on top by 20. West back to throw. The ball is batted down. We talked about the length of DeForest Buckner. How about 6'7 to 290?
No, he's just, to me, another great story of student athletes. I mean, he could have gone. He was projected to go higher than Eric Armstead, went in the first round of the National Football League, and he decided to come back because he made a commitment to his family and, more importantly, himself. He'd get his degree. We had a chance to talk to him yesterday. So excited to come back, not to just be a part of the program, but to be able to get that diploma.
Second and 10 now. This is Kupp with a reception. Kivett move across the 10. And got to the pylon, touchdown. Cooper Kupp with the touchdown. And again, a terrific maneuver after the catch.
Playing receiver is all about being savvy. He understands how to utilize the speed and agility of Ugo Amadi, true freshman, playing corner against him. He knew he'd overrun him running inside. He knew he'd be able to turn to his outside, and then he knew he's stronger than him. And he just worked his way into the end zone. That's graduate level play by Cooper Kupp.
How about 7 catches, 159 yards today, Yogi, and a touchdown for Kupp.
You had a chance to talk to him about a week and a half ago at practice. He didn't flinch when I asked him, hey, you're going to be a little nervous? He said, no way. I was born to play on big stages, and he's showing up today.
Oregon Ducks leading Eastern Washington 34-21. The combination of Jordan West and Cooper Kupp has been particularly effective here in the first half in Eugene.
7 grabs, 159 yards, and he's made game-changing type plays. This thing could have been blown wide open. He makes a big-time play early on in the second quarter, down inside the 5, touchdown right there. This is a young man. He's been doing it his whole career. But it doesn't matter what level of football. He's kind of in Vernon Adams' build in that regard.
Myron Marshall settles under it. Speeds across the 30, a burst of speed to the 40, and is spun down at the 41-yard line. Another good return by Myron Marshall in excellent field position for Vernon Adams and company. Adams, 11 of 15, 163 yards and a touchdown. And Jordan West, who was his understudy a year ago at Eastern Washington, 20 of 26, 271, three touchdowns and one interception.
Well, when Vernon Adams Jr. got hurt last year, it allowed Jordan West to play in four games, get four starts. And that was critical for him, this not being his first game ever. Keep in mind, he's a former walk-on. Everybody overlooked him as well. This entire team of Eastern Washington has a chip on their shoulder. They want to prove that what they've done there, A, it would have been good enough for Vernon Adams to stay, and also they'd be able to play at this level.
Adams on first down, will hand off, they go ground. And Royce Freeman again is called upon. Eastern Washington, a good road team, Yogi. They've scored at least 27 points in the last 11 road games. They know how to get it done. Here are flags flying now as Oregon quickly hustled back to the line of scrimmage.
Ball start. Offense, number 73. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Now, because Oregon goes so fast with their tempo, they really have to be efficient. If they have a dismal drive or two, all of a sudden that could be a lull because the offense isn't on the field for a long time. And all of a sudden, Eastern Washington gets a lot of time to allow that offense to cool off.
Adams will keep. Avoids a couple of tacklers and then is spun down just across the line of scrimmage. Alec Kaczmarczyk, the freshman from Woodinville, Washington, comes up to make the stop from his linebacker spot. So it'll be third and seven for the Oregon Ducks. Ducks are 3 for 4 today and converting on third down. Third and long now for Adams. He'll duck it and run. He spins just shy of the 50-yard line. Mitch Fettig buried him. Boy, he took a shot.
Yeah, and this defense, they're excited to go up against Vernon Adams. Keep in mind, he went on his official visit, University of Oregon, when he was still a student athlete at Eastern Washington.
Fourth down, they give to Freeman. He works the wing, he shakes and turns, and gets to the far hash mark for a first down. Kaczmarczyk came up to make the stop again with Rashad Wadu assisting.
They really like Kaczmarczyk. He was the preseason freshman of the year in their conference. He's played well today.
So with first down, Vernon Adams now has some options. He has Royce Freeman in the backfield. He's got Marshall and Addison flanked here to the near side. Hard rush, he is spun around and knocked down. Samson Abukum comes up to make the stop, the junior from Portland.
Comes off the edge, just gets an extra step on Tyrell Crosby, the right tackle. Abukum, he can play that stand-up outside backer, end position athlete.
They give it to Freeman, finds some room, threading his way out to near the 30-yard line before Zach Bruce came up to make the stop.
Such patience getting through the line. Just takes his time, knows where his holes are, can set up his blockers. And then he just turns it on, and you're not going to be able to arm tackle him.
Again, they call on Freeman, and he pushes the pile across the 30-yard line. He's carried it now 13 times for 90 yards on the afternoon. He'll get a breather, and Kanai Benoit will step in now for the Oregon Ducks. They'll make that Tony Brooks James, who has a touchdown already today. He'll come out of the backfield. That ball thrown in his vicinity, and it looked like it grazed the hip. Was it tipped, though, by the man in coverage? Take a look.
And that one's a little bit of a miss on Vernon Adams. You got to lead him. Brooks James wide open up against the backer.
That was Kurt Calhoun in coverage. And now third down, Tony Brooks James is bottled up. Abukum makes the stop. Fourth down and six now for Oregon. They have not been bashful about going for it on fourth down. They are 2 for 2 this afternoon.
This is where they really stress defenses. Make the run, allow Vernon Adams the ability to run and throw here.
Tonight, Benoit, the man in the backfield, play action. Adams pump fakes, fires to the near side, has a man wide open, and it was dropped. Byron Marshall looking it right to the mitts, just couldn't collect it. Delando Tucker was there looking on in coverage.
Well, it was a simple slant and go. Beat the corner easily. Just allowed the ball to get to his body. Those, you got to go up and grab the football. You know the cornerback is trying to close in. They don't know where the ball is. Only you do. Hernandez, no. They let one slip away there. But how about the defense of Eastern Washington, Kevin? Mm-hmm. I mean, this team, you just go back to a year ago. On the road in Seattle at UW, they're down three scores quick. And all of a sudden, they fight their way back in. Vernon Adams, a huge reason why. I wouldn't say they're definitely 100% back in, but they didn't lay down by any stretch of the imagination. This team has shown the competitive grit that gave them the worthiness of being the sixth team in the country in FCS football.
Lost that game to Washington 59-52, and Adams had the seven touchdowns that day through the air and no interceptions. On first down, Eastern Washington throwing. Kendrick Bourne out at the far sideline is spun around by Chris Cisse.
This is tricky here if you're Bo Baldwin. You want to make sure that you utilize all the clock on this drive, but specifically this series. If you don't get a first down, you want to make sure you take as much time off as you possibly can.
Cooper Kupp, seven grabs on the day. They go to the ground and effectively. Jabari Wilson Carson, California, the junior, marching off to the far side, a flag.
Holding, offense number 11, 10-yard penalty, second down.
You see Kendrick Bourne. Just fighting hands inside, and that's a tough one. You got to let him go when the running back gets past you. The right call, but as a receiver, you don't really know what's happening. So when you feel the back go past you, that's when you really have to let go, because it wasn't a hold until the back was already past him.
Second and five now for Jordan West. Cooper Kupp makes the reception, but immediately is shoved out of bounds. And it brings up third down for the Eagles. Stick around for the State Farm Halftime Report with Mike Yam, Lincoln Kennedy, and Nigel Burton back in the Pac-12 Network Studios. Take a look at ASU invading SEC territory. The Rosen won at UCLA. And Stanford goes to Chicago, and they lose to Northwestern. West back to throw. And as he delivered the ball, he took a lick. The intended receiver was Jabari Wilson. I'm not sure West could even see him.
Tyson Coleman, he's played a lot of football. Fifth-year senior out of Lake Oswego, playing his best football right now. Really playing a lot of different players at that outside backer, defensive end, hybrid type position. And the returning starter, he made his presence felt on that rush.
So it brings up fourth down in Eastern Washington with just under a minute remaining. We'll punt it. Braylon Addison is back. And a timeout call on the field. Well, Eastern Washington has been a very successful operation. Bo Baldwin in his eighth year there. They have won three straight Big Sky titles and, of course, won a national championship in the FCS in 2010.
They really have a way about them. You know, you go to practice and they don't have the greatest facilities in the world, but they continue to grow and grow and grow. They built that new stadium, the Inferno. People get rocking there. I mean, they have a unique brand of football. And Bo Baldwin, you talk to coaches around the country, he's as respected as anybody. Two-time Big Sky Coach of the Year. I believe that Eastern Washington is really lucky that they still have him.
Yeah.
You know, he's going to get his opportunity at a bigger school. Not sure if he necessarily will take it. He loves it there. He loves what they built there, really proud of it. He's one of the brightest offensive minds in the entire country.
Eastern will kick. Addison is back. Fair catch called for, and it'll settle in at his own 21-yard line. So 48 seconds remaining in the half, and Vernon Adams is summoned back out onto the field. Jeff Locke, the backup quarterback. Of course, for the last couple of years here at Oregon. And in the competition, Vernon Adams came in and roughly in 2 weeks won the job.
Yeah, you got to give Jeff Locke credit. Complete class act, preparing still like the starter. And this is a great situation here for him, not only as a communicator to Vernon Adams in a two-minute drill, but also for Vernon Adams how to operate this type of situation.
Adams will throw on first down, and he swings one over the middle. That one caught by the durable tight end of the Oregon Ducks. Johnny Munt, his first catch of the afternoon. They quickly go back to it. Royce Freeman out of the backfield to the far side for a first down.
29 seconds, you think it was not a lot for Oregon. They're feeling good. This is what they do. Two timeouts, a lot of time. Variety of tempos here at Oregon. Green light that's kind of super fast. Yellow light is medium. And red light when they check to the coaches on the sideline.
Marshall and Addison wide to the near side. Adams back, checks left, moves right. He's rolling out and he pump fakes and he's driven out of bounds. Jake Gall got over there in coverage, the sophomore from Play Elm, Washington. So with 21 seconds left in second down, Adams again hustles him to the line of scrimmage. Adams pump fakes, now he'll run it. He has the first down and more across the 50. He's going to slide down to the 41-yard line and they'll call a timeout with 12 seconds remaining. Mitch Fettig makes the stop. More football coming your way here on the Pac-12 Network. Number 8 USC with Cody Kessler behind at center. Play host to Arkansas State next on Pac-12 Network. Pac-12 Now app or Pac-12.com, followed by Pac-12 Final Score.
Cody Kessler, his numbers last year were just video game-esque. I mean, just silly. He puts up numbers close to this. He's going to be in New York for the Heisman Trophy. And really, he's grown, though, beyond just those numbers. He is really the leader. He's taken on everything there, and that's what happens when you're a USC quarterback in Los Angeles. Excited to watch him play tonight and some of his weapons. Juju Smith-Schuster, an absolutely dominant wide receiver. I think he's an all-Pac-12 caliber player.
With a handoff here, bouncing out to the far side, Royce Freeman. And gets the first down, races out of bounds at the 26-yard line. The clock stops with 7 seconds.
This is interesting right here, 7 seconds left. How about the confidence they have and the functional football intelligence of this offense to know how much time is left and what they need to do here.
Adams looks to a man flanking out to the far side. And Johnny Munt sure-handedly hauls it in and rolls out of bounds at the 21.
That's great efficiency. There are not a lot of coaches in the country that would say, okay, 7 seconds left, let's run another snap with a first-time starter in your program. First time really playing this offense against an opponent in the first game of the season. That's impressive. That just shows what Vernon Adams has done in the film room. In specific situations, that's how you win Pac-12 championships.
Aiden Snyder has been summoned out onto the field for the field goal attempt. 11 of 12 field goals as a true freshman last year.
You know him, former walk-on, kind of came out of nowhere, beat out Matt Wogan. He's going to have to make some critical kicks as the season goes on.
Yep. We'll spot this one at the 28-yard line. Snap the hold. The kick is up. And the kick is good. 38-yarder for Aiden Snyder. And Oregon goes to the locker room with a lead of 16, a 37-21. Very interesting first half.
Well, Jordan West, he's played well. Cooper Kupp, he's been superhuman at times, really. Vernon Adams, really efficient. You got to be impressed if you're an Oregon fan.
Let's go down to Lewis Johnson standing by with Mark Helfrich.
All right, thanks very much. What are your thoughts on how Vernon Adams has played and led your squad so far this first half?
Sporadically. You know, he's done some really good things. Missed a couple wide-open touchdowns, missed a couple protection checks. But overall, you know, offensively, we're playing okay. Defensively, way too sloppy.
All right, so what do you do to clean up that defensive play?
Tackle. Do your job and tackle. We've got some guys guessing and ducking their head and, you know, shoulders all galaxy.
Okay. All right, thanks, Mark.
Thanks, Lewis.
Kevin?
Well, he did look all galaxy in the first half, as a matter of fact. Half the Ducks on top by 16, 37-21. We'll take you to Mike Yam in the Pac-12 Network studios in a moment here on the Pac-12 Network. Number 7, Oregon, leading at half, 37-21. The Eastern Washington Eagles have been effective through the air. Standing by, Lewis Johnson, chatting with Bo Baldwin, the coach of the Eagles.
Well, Coach, let's start with your offense, led by Jordan West. Your thoughts on their efficiency in the first half?
I thought we did some really good things, especially game one. I mean, there's still some things you want to clean up, and, you know, we know that, and there'll be plenty of things to coach. But overall, you know, considering the noise and using silent count and, you know, having to use a little bit more sometimes pass as an extension of the run game, I thought they've operated fairly well. But, again, we're looking for to make improvements into the second half.
All right, now that you've seen the speed and efficiency of Oregon live in person, what's the challenge here in the second half to try and slow that and Vernon Adams down?
Yeah, it's tough. I mean, that's the thing. You have to make things as difficult as you can. You know they're going to get their yards. You have to find ways to maybe find a red zone stop or a turnover because they're going to move it from 20 to 20. And you have to keep working. We went through a phase where we didn't tackle, you know, but that's also a credit to them. They got guys that are hard to tackle. But we got to make sure we're low and we're disciplined. I thought our tackling improved as we went towards the second, you know, the end of that first half. So hopefully we'll just continue that in the second half where we left off the first.
All right, Coach, thanks a lot.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Kevin?
Well, thank you, Lewis. Take a look at the numbers. A whole lot of yards there amassed by Oregon, 452. But the same thing for Eastern Washington can be said, 299. And on the ground, they were not effective with just the 22 yards. Oregon, 271. Third down conversions, 3 of 6 for Oregon. Fourth down conversions, 3 of 3 for Eastern Washington. Eastern Washington has not hurt themselves. West was intercepted, but remember, they immediately got the ball back when Vernon Adams fumbled the football, and Eastern Washington will get the football now to start this third quarter play. And Jordan West has been outstanding, and they have not really gotten to the quarterback today.
Well, no sacks. I mean, he hasn't flinched in this environment. Remember, a year ago, he filled in for Vernon Adams, started 4 games, went 3-1, and he's got some weapons. And this is a group of receivers that is good as anybody Oregon's going to see for the most part throughout this season in terms of running discipline routes and catching the ball. They'll see better athletes at times, but what Cooper Kupp has done and the wide receiver going up against these young DBs, what Shaq Hill has done, Kendrick Bourne, I mean, that is the advantage for Eastern Washington through one half of play.
Kupp, Hill, and Bourne each with a touchdown reception. But Cooper Kupp has been dynamite with 160 yards on 8 catches. On first down to start this third quarter of play, they summon Jabari Wilson. And he is stacked up. Eastern Washington running the ball just enough to offset Oregon, get that lingering doubt to Oregon. But you heard Mark Helfrich in his conversation with Lewis Johnson. The defense unacceptable in his mind in the first half. Way too sloppy. Jabari Wilson again gets the call here on second down.
And the biggest thing for this offense, Eastern Washington, is just dictating their own tempo. And to do that, you have to have success on first down like they did. So now you're in 3rd and 4. This is an easily convertible down if you're Eastern Washington with the way your receivers have played thus far.
Wilson, the man in motion out of the backfield. Hard rush. West is brought down and sacked for the first time this afternoon. It was Joe Walker who busted in there, the senior from Palos Verdes, California.
And that's a straight run through by Joe Walker. Not even touched. Right to the left of your screen. Oregon does a nice job of making sure they send a lot of bodies at the offensive line. They understand who has to block who, who's responsible for who. Aaron Neary, the left guard, he was on the nose tackle. Alex Balducci there. All of a sudden, Walker just a clean run through for the first sack of the game.
Piscato will lift this one high into the air. Under it is Braylon Addison breaking to the 50. There's a flag way back here at the 45-yard line of the Oregon Ducks. And Eagles territory.
Tell you what, Ducks, they've been close a couple times of busting one, whether it's a kickoff return or punt return.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Receiving team, number 26. A 10-yard penalty will be enforced from the spot of the foul. First down.
Penalty goes to the Ducks. They'll have the football when we come back. Just underway here in the third quarter.
And welcome back. And let's take a look at this run game of Oregon at the X's and O's. This offensive line doesn't get a lot of credit, and their athletes don't either. Because of the tempo they play out, they get defenses to over-pursue. And what does that do? Well, it allows for big plays by these really athletic running backs of Oregon. Royce Freeman, Tony Brooks-James, then back to Freeman. Look at that offensive line. In this zone running scheme, they have the ability just to put their bodies between the defender and the back, and their backs can do the rest.
Royce Freeman will take it. Gets a block out on the edge. Avoids a tackler. Plows ahead near midfield. And Freeman once again has picked up a large swath of ground. Rashad Wadu comes up with the stop.
Well, running backs, they're taught to deliver it every once in a while. How about that? Royce Freeman doesn't even slow down.
Well, Wadu tried to stop him. Here is Freeman spinning across the 50-yard line, and he is upended.
You could tell with Oregon. You saw a picture of Mark Helfrich. They're getting the tempo going. That's when they're at their best. They've got three tempos. Green tempo when they can go as fast as possible. Yellow tempo when it's a little bit more controlled, and then red when they look to the sideline for the play. But when they're in green tempo, that's when they're at their best.
Second and five, Adams. The handoff. Freeman breaks three and is slipped up at the 35-yard line by Mitch Fettig, who's able to just get a piece of the shoe. Gain of 12 for the big man. Micaiah down on the field for Eastern Washington.
That's tough. That's a captain, their middle linebacker. Second team all Big Sky preseason. And he can really run. He's big on this defense. Played defensive back in high school. You hope to see him back in this game.
Micaiah Zamora, the co-captain. Pasco, Washington. Well, Freeman checks out. Can I Ben Wise in? Offset to the left of Vernon Adams, who goes to work on first down. Fakes the handoff, settles in. Scans, adjusts, throws on the run to his left, and a complete pass down inside the 10-yard line. Byron Marshall with a catch.
I can remember Pete Carroll telling me, sometimes at quarterback position, you want the guy that you'd pick first in the backyard if you're playing backyard football. Well, that's a backyard football play. Vernon Adams, he's made so many of those in his career. Things break down.
The game was stopped for an injury timeout.
But things break down, and he has such a natural ability to keep his eyes up, and he's been doing it since he was in high school. See Russell Wilson do that with the Seattle Seahawks, someone Vernon Adams Jr. looks up to. It's an element that Mark Helfrich said has really allowed this offense to flourish, extending plays. You've seen it with Marcus Mariota for years, now with Vernon Adams at the helm.
JT Teoli, the man shaken up for Eastern Washington. He'll come over to the sideline. And the Ducks, after stopping Eastern Washington, three and out, now take charge, first and goal. And they swing it here to the near side to Ben Wall, who hesitates, tries to bounce to the boundary, and then he is driven back. Can I Ben Wall?
Defensive, Jeff Schmetting, new defensive coordinator. Remember, their big change last year at Eastern Washington, making him the defensive coordinator, going to more of a 4-2-5 scheme. You get athletes who can run to the football. Great example right there by Eastern Washington.
Raines and Calhoun, the first to it. Adams lingering that handoff to Benoit. looked like he was going to tuck it and took it out of there. Mitch Fettig stops Adams down there inside the 5-yard line of the Eagles. So it's third and goal. Freeman trips up and is stopped at about the 2-yard line. Now they're going to call it, spotted at the 1. And back they come, fourth and goal. Here's Adams. The handoff comes to Freeman, and he's in the end zone. Royce Freeman, 230 pounds. Chiseled, leaps into the end zone. Touchdown, Oregon.
When they're running tempo in the field, it's hard. But it's even harder when they're going fast inside the 5 because you just can't really get a line. Taking advantage of it, they go for it on fourth down to get the touchdown. But that's vintage Mark Helfrich and Oregon offense inside the 5-yard line.
That's his third touchdown run of the evening, Royce Freeman. Aiden Schneider now for the extra point as the Ducks lead at 43-21 with 10:29 to go in the third. Snap the hold, the kick is up, and the Ducks lead at 44-21. Vernon Adams stirring it up here at Autzen Stadium, and the Ducks in command. Let's take a look at the Heisman Watch presented by Nissan, premier partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Well, when you look at the Pac-12, I think Adoree Jackson, Cody Kessler, they're going to have big years. Adoree Jackson, a gifted athlete. Royce Freeman, Oregon's going to have success. He's a dominant player. And I can remember all three of those young men in high school at the Elite 11 or at the opening. Really sound mentally, really gifted athletes, not just on the field, but also off it. Those young men have a chance to get to New York City.
Matt Wogan to kick off. Eastern Washington will take the touchback. Royce Freeman, 3 touchdowns on the ground here tonight.
He's dominant. I mean, he's an All-American candidate for sure at the running back position. Last year, freshman All-American, was really dominant when you think about what he did all season long and the durability of playing running back in this system. This year, they're going to lean on him more. Tonight has been a great example. And he's really grown. You know, we had a chance to talk to him media day. He's become more vocal. The coaching staff has asked him to be more of that. But he's a dominant threat. I mean, he really is. He's kind of like that Greek statue. And you touch him on the shoulders or on the arm, he is an absolute rock. And he's learned from one of the best in Gary Campbell, not only one of the top running back coaches in the country, but his players. They also say he's the best dressed guy on the staff.
Oh, he had a white fedora on the way into the ballgame this afternoon. Very clean. Flags fly on the play. Movement.
False start. Offense number 79. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Well, Eastern Washington trying to rekindle that magic of the first half. They scored 3 touchdowns, and their quarterback, Jordan West, was untouched for a sack. They went 3 and out in their first series, and West was indeed knocked to the stadium turf for the first sack of the evening when Joe Walker got to him. And now they go to work here on 1st and 15. West drops back to pass, throws long, intending it for Cooper Kupp.
And he took a shot in the back of, I'm sure that Don Pelham, when he talked to his defense, said we have to get after it. What he tries to chart now with this defense is not necessarily sacks, pass breakups, picks. It's disrupting the offense. How many times can we disrupt them from their flow? Didn't do it enough in the first half. But on these first 2 drives, they clearly have been disrupting Jordan West in this Eastern Washington offense.
Brings up 2nd and 15 now. West will roll out. Plants his foot and throws long down the field, and that is underthrown, and excellent coverage down there. As West looks like he's cramping up a little bit. Arian Springs was in coverage down the field. The intended receiver was Nick Splendorio.
Oregon's just getting pressure with their guys up front. And it looks like he just cramped up, and those are tough because once they start, they don't really go away.
He is hobbling back there on 3rd down and 15. West slings with him to the far side. An outstanding pass. Kendrick Bourne hauls it in for an Eastern Washington University first down. Outstanding ball thrown out there by West.
Well, the quarterback position in Eastern Washington has always been extremely gritty. I mean, even last year, Vernon Adams breaks his foot against Idaho State. and he still plays the rest of the game, wills him to win. Jordan West, he's in that meeting room. He's taking on that type of personality as well.
First down for the Eagles. And they go to the ground. Sam McPherson will get a touch, the freshman from Bothell, Washington. TJ Janiel comes up with the stop. Second and seven down.
If I'm Eastern Washington, I'm working the top of the field right now. The top of your screen, got Cooper Kupp, Kendrick Bourne.
They're on the short side of the field. West is back to throw. He looks in that direction. The ball is tipped. Went through the hands of Bourne, and Kupp, for a moment, looked like he was going to have an opportunity to grab it.
You can see Oregon, they're playing a little bit more aggressive, a little more confident in the line of scrimmage and press coverage. They're coming off the ball on the defensive line with a little bit more juice.
Third and seven, West back to throw, trying to find McPherson coming out of the backfield. That ball's thrown too far out in front. And it'll bring up a fourth down.
And he knows he can't miss that. It's the second one this game that Jordan West has missed on that little bubble screen to his left. If blockers out in front of him, makes it a little more easier, and they're going to go for it here on fourth down, or why not? They're 3-for-3.
3-for-3, fourth and seven. Ducks on four across the front. They bring five. West backs up. Ball tipped, went off the fingertips of the intended receiver, Bourne, but a flag flies on the play. Rodney Hardrick was down there with Kendrick Bourne.
There are fouls by both teams, and they will offset. Pass interference, offense number 10, personal foul, roughing the passer, defense number 45, offsetting fouls, replay, fourth down.
TJ Daniel in the backfield. Those are tough. Those are tough calls. You got to know better because you're going to call it every time.
And Cooper Kupp was flagged for Eastern Washington. So they offset, and we do it again, fourth and seven. West steps up, flags fly again. And he is tripped up shy of the first down. And West still having trouble with that left leg.
Personal foul, hands to the face, defense number 96. A 15-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run with an automatic first down.
Christian French penalized. So a first down for Eastern Washington, and they were able to move it now with 8:58 remaining in the third. Six penalties on Oregon.
Yeah, he's right here, the bottom of your screen. Guys compete and fight, but those are just simple things you can't do.
Riley Hennessy is in, the freshman from Camas, Washington. They'll go to the ground, and Sam McPherson is summoned here to the near sideline. He is spilled. Hennessy, 6'3", 200-pound freshman, Yogi, and he was a good one in the state of Washington, Gatorade Player of the Year in 13.
Yeah, threw 64 touchdowns.
Sideline warning, Oregon.
Working that cramp out, you can see Jordan West. That's tough when you get this part of the game. You know, you got your ankles taped, trying to get as much blood flow to that area as you possibly can. But Hennessy's a thrower, he's a pure passer.
Hennessy settles in. Quick trigger here to the near side, and another flag.
Holding. Defense number 12, a 10-yard penalty. An automatic first down.
Chris Cisse, the guilty party. Terrence Grady was the intended receiver.
You can bang as much as you want at the line of scrimmage, but you can't grab the jersey. Officials this year, we had our seminar before the season. This is a big point of emphasis.
Seventh penalty on Oregon, Yogi. And Eastern now in a first down situation again. Hennessy backs up and throws. And the pass complete. Coming back to get it to help his quarterback was Kendrick Bourne.
And I keep working him. I mean, you clearly the defense, they're rolling towards Cooper Kupp. They're trying to play a two-man, which is two deep safeties, man-to-man underneath. You have the ability with a big target like Kendrick Bourne to get underneath the corner, keep throwing those slant routes.
That corner is Ugo Amadi, a freshman, seeing his first action. Hennessy back to throw, flushed out of the pocket. Flags fly again on the backside. This may be against Eastern. TJ Daniel in pursuit. Now a flag flies down there. So we have two penalties.
Well, you're going to get a hold and then a personal foul.
Fouls by both teams. Holding. Offense number 79. After the play, personal foul, late hit. Defense number 86. Both penalties are reinforced. An automatic first down.
See the hold on the right of your screen. Cassidy Curtis. And then, I mean, that's just, yeah. You can't do that. I mean, you got to be better than that.
Rodney Prevo, he should know better, a junior from Houston, Texas. So penalties to Oregon, 7 for 55 yards, and Eastern, 6 penalties, 38 yards. And Eastern really has not had to do much here, Yogi, to advance the football. It's been all penalties now that have gotten them down here to the 22-yard line, but their starting quarterback still on the bench getting treatment. Well, you have to feel great if you're the Eagles right now.
I'd take a shot if I were them. Man coverage.
Hennessy with a handoff and nearly slipping away. They go back to the ground.
Keep in mind for Oregon, this is a senior-laden front seven, an extremely young back end. And there have been a variety of mental errors throughout this entire drive, so frustration mounts.
Now West really limping around back there and grimacing. Malcolm West, the ball carrier, he is fourth on the three deep. So they are spreading the wealth back there in the backfield for Eastern. Trying to cobble it together, doing a pretty good job right now. Hennessy is again flush, but he's got all kinds of room. He works just shy of the 12-yard line and very close to the first down. May have it.
And sometimes when backup quarterbacks come in, especially the defensive linemen, you get in a rhythm throughout early parts of the game into the third quarter. A little injured to see his other quarterback, how he rolls out, how he deals with pressure. Twice on this drive, you've seen Hennessy spin out to his left, something Jordan West has not done once. He's actually climbed the pocket every time there's been pressure.
First down, Jabari Wilson will get the call. He scoots left side, one-on-one. He goes right to the one-yard line. Chris Cisse was able to stop him right at the threshold. Joe Walker there as well.
And he barely got him. And this is exactly what Mark Helfrich talked with Lewis Johnson about at halftime. We got a tackle. Chris Cisse overruns it, over-pursues. Great job at the running back position, just putting your foot in the ground in Wilson and getting up the field.
Cooper Kupp is flanked out far to the far side. Riley Hennessy, the quarterback. He wants to check at the line. Jabari Wilson is the lone setback. They look for Kupp. They throw a low ball. Hennessy throws a dime in the end zone and a touchdown. Touchdown, Cooper Kupp. Scooping up that low ball from Riley Hennessy.
How about this? Hennessy, first he changes the play at the line of scrimmage like he's Peyton Manning. And then just drops a dime on the slant route to Cooper Kupp like he's been there before.
And again, they went right at the freshman cornerback, Ugo Amadi, who had some difficulties in that series. Eastern to add the extra point. And they are in business. 44-28, 5:35 to go in the third quarter of play. Riley Hennessy, the freshman, with a beautiful pass to Kupp. This Pac-12 football broadcast is presented by Bank of the West. Yogi Roth, Kevin Calabro, Lewis Johnson here at Autzen Stadium in Eugene, Oregon, where the Ducks hold a lead at 44-28. Ducks penalized five times, two of them offset on that drive by Eastern Washington, capped by a touchdown pass from Riley Hennessy, getting his first collegiate snaps. The redshirt freshman hooks up with Cooper Kupp, and then an offside kick, and the ball batted around, and a flag flies.
Not sure if that went 10.
I don't think it did. It may have gone 8.
It's going to be about all who touched it first. You can see the official who touched the ball. You read his lips.
The result of the play is recovered by the kicking team. However, offside, kicking team number 30. 5-yard penalty, free kick.
Yeah, you can see it. Right to the left of the kicker, Curtis Bellin. Great call by Bo Bolin.
Great idea. Great idea.
Why not? And that's tough on those because the kicker sometimes hesitates a little. Usually you don't practice this a lot. Usually as a staff, you practice it on Friday and your walkthrough, you go through that outside of a time or two in training camp. You'll see it right next to the kicker. Right there. It's actually Cole Karstetter. See him? Right over the line. Just a tad early. Great idea, great hustle, great call. Bo Bolin, he's always kind of been a gambler. He's taking a run at it.
Why not?
Well, why not is right. I mean, they've got the energy right now in this stadium.
Marshall going for it, but it was taken by the up man, Addison. And he is thrown down near the 30-yard line. Well, let's go to San Francisco now for an update from Mike Yam.
All right, Kevin, now time for your Bank of the West game break. Texas A&M up 17-14. Aggies able to gain control. As we take a closer look here, it's Kyle Allen started the game for Texas A&M. The 12-yard touchdown run just moments ago, though. It's the Aggies putting another touchdown on the board. So it's 30-17. Back to Eugene we go. Kevin, Yogi, and Lewis.
Becky Mike Vernon Adams Jr. was the story at the beginning of this ball game, coming back to play against his ex-teammates, Eastern Washington University, and this is final year of collegiate eligibility. We'll hand off to Royce Freeman, who already has three touchdowns on the ground. He breaks it near to the 50. He's out near to the 40-yard line, and he's finally run out of bounds. Mitch Fettig, who weighs all of 175, trying to get in front of the locomotive. 230-pound Royce Freeman, it did. Cut him off. But not before Oregon works it deep into Eastern Washington territory for a first down.
Well, you only have so many opportunities if you're Eastern Washington. They had Royce Freeman tackled in the backfield. He broke from that, and now all of a sudden the momentum has shifted.
Addison in motion, low snap, gathered in by Vernon Adams Jr., flushed out of the pocket, throws on the run complete. Just shy of a first down to the far side. Making a comeback after a year off because of injury, Braylon Addison. He has been very active. He has been targeted by Vernon Adams. Rashad Wadu makes the stop on the play. Brings up second and one. They're going to go for the bundle. Touchdown, Oregon. Byron Marshall holds it in. Marshall at the pylon and a beautifully thrown ball by Vernon Adams. Rashad Wadu was there, but he was screened beautifully by Byron Marshall.
It's a back shoulder throw, and they teach you to throw right to the back of the helmet. Beautifully placed by Vernon Adams Jr., Byron Marshall, their most consistent, probably their most talented receiver top to bottom. Made the shift from running back 2 years ago, 1,000-yard rusher, 1,000-yard receiver. And that's usually a throw, a pass, and a catch. They're going to check probably.
Is under review.
Yeah, they're going to review it just to see where he was down. But what's most impressive about that is that that relationship of the back shoulder throw is something that takes months to develop. And Vernon Adams has not been here for a month.
And what do you see there, Yogi? Looks like the backside is right on the goal line and the ball there at his belt buckle.
But yeah, it's got to be conclusive evidence to overturn it. Remember, the call was a touchdown. Difference this year, too, for all the fans, they show these replays in the stadium. They just put it up, and you can hear the fans kind of going a little bit.
I don't think the fans are one way or the other. It's about 50-50 here at Hudson Stadium right now.
It's all about the ball. It's not about the body. I think it's going to be too close to overturn.
Yeah. Calling the field as touchdown. And the officials in the review booth will have four different looks at it.
After review, the rim on the field stands. Touchdown.
Well, they come right back to Byron Marshall for the touchdown pass. And Vernon Adams now on the evening. 17 of 23, 239 yards and two touchdowns through the air. And he has not been intercepted. Aiden Schneider to add the extra point. And the Ducks have put 51 on the board. They have won 10 consecutive home openers and have averaged 55 points in doing so. They're nearly there now here in the third.
Well, welcome back. Look at that beautiful setting here in Eugene. Pac-12 after dark, and it almost started a trend on Twitter, right? Keep an eye on Monique Sarte, okay? He's playing that defensive end position. He's got a chance to tackle Royce Freeman, misses the tackle, and all of a sudden, big-time gain for Oregon. Momentum completely shifts. They score a touchdown. It's a different type of ball game. But the momentum in this stadium, Kevin, was completely different before that run. They had a chance to make a play, and when the staff of Eastern Washington goes back and watches this game, they're going to look at that play and say, oh, that was an opportunity for us.
And then, of course, Vernon Adams goes right for the quick strike and finds Byron Marshall in the end zone for the touchdown. Simba Webster, a freshman, jitterbugs his way over here to the 30-yard line in front of his own bench. He got flattened. Let's go down to Lewis Johnson with an update on the Eastern Washington starting quarterback.
Yeah, you see he's got the helmet off, and he just got some news that he didn't want to hear. Jordan West told that he's not going to be going back in the game. I mean, he was absolutely locked up earlier. They were rolling out both the calves, the quads, hamstrings, everything, walking a lot better. But looks like the coaches have decided that he is done for the night.
And he was good tonight, Yogi. 23 of 34, 293. And he and Cooper Kupp had a connection going in the first half. Mark Helfrich told Lewis Johnson at half, we're making Kupp look like he's all galaxy. Back to throw, Riley Hennessy throws this one on time. Eye high to Terrence Grady, the big man from Kent, Washington. He hauls it in. He's a yard shy of the first down. It'll bring up second down to the Eagles.
Hennessy showed complete command of the system.
Yep.
Check to the line of scrimmage. See the officials coming in because of a substitution. They're really all over that this year. And one team substitutes, making sure the other one has the opportunity to do so.
Tennessee pressured, spins away from pressure, throwing on the run to the near side, and the Eagles have a first down. Nick Splendorio makes the catch, but what a move by Hennessy.
Sometimes it's better when you're a young player. You don't even know any better, right? You don't even realize you're in Austin Stadium and it's sold out again. You're just playing. You're just balling. You watch his high school film coming out of Commerce High School. And this young man, he's been playing this way his whole life.
Richard French thought he had him locked up. He didn't. Now he throws another beauty on the run. Angling here to the center of the field. Cooper Kupp coming near side, trying to cut back, puts his head down for a few more. He's down at the 21-yard line.
They're going crazy in Yakima right now. Cooper Kupp, he's sneaky fast. I mean, you wonder how many teams in the Pac-12 conference, how'd they miss on this young man? Dad, grandfather played in the NFL. He's got natural football skills, and he wants to rock in critical moments. And not about him playing well, but also their quarterback, Riley Hennessy. You kidding me? On the run, two times in a row, first downs.
Kupp, 10 catches, 198 yards, two touchdowns. Now they go to the tight end. Hennessy again throws it right on the money in stride to Terrence Grady, a big target at 6'5", and he angles inside the 5-yard line of the Oregon Ducks.
Last two plays look like 7-on-7. He's out there dealing. And that's a credit to the receivers of Eastern Washington. They're playing well. They've been attacking the secondary.
Well, he checks the plays and now aligns him at the goal line. The lone man in the backfield is the 200-pound junior from Carson, California, Jabari Wilson. The pass, too tall, off the fingertips of the intended receiver, Kendrick Bourne. Well, Hennessy put a little mustard on that one.
Love the game plan by Bo. Love the game plan by Bo Baldwin. Now you get your backup quarterback in there. The most hostile environment you're going to see all season long. And he just keeps calling. It's all similar when Vernon Adams Jr. went out a year ago and Jordan West had to go in. He came in and led him to a victory.
Second and goal. Tennessee in the gun. Drops back and throws to the far post. And a little fade route intended for Kendrick Bourne. Too far out in front of him. Chris Cisse is in coverage. He has a few things to say to Mr. Bourne.
Yeah, I'd go to Bourne down here in the red zone again, especially if you're going to go on the fade route. Athletic size, and it's third down. You know this is four down territory, though. They're going for it on third and fourth.
Here are the Eagles now. The handoff coming to the little man, Jabari Wilson, spinning like a tap into the end zone. Touchdown, Eagles. Eastern Washington on the board again. 51-34 count with 2:13 left in the third.
They just don't go away. Oh, they did it last year against UW when they played against the Pac-12 caliber opponent. The year before, they jumped all over Oregon State. I mean, you have got to give Bo Baldwin credit for preparing everyone on this team, backup quarterback included.
Snap the hold, the kick is up, and the Eagles are down 16 on the road to the number 7 Oregon Ducks with 2:13 left here in the third.
Eastern Washington had every chance to just pack it in. Good effort, they competed hard, and they haven't done it once. Bo Baldwin, again, that's setting the culture. I had a chance to go watch them practice. Workmanlike practice, fun practice, efficient practice. A lot of teams, when they go in these situations, even teams in the Pac-12 when they play Oregon, they hope the ball bounces their way. They don't know it's going to bounce their way. This is a team that showed up tonight. They knew they were going to have some success, and they have against the secondary.
Riley Hennessy can't say enough about the poise of that youngster, the redshirt freshman, stepping in and leading him down the field for a couple of touchdowns.
I mean, think about it. He's stepping under center and looking across the line, seeing DeForest Buckner, Balducci, Henry Mondu, Christian Friend, Tyson Coleman, Rodney. I mean, dudes across the line of scrimmage. He's never seen those guys.
These cats were in the national championship a year ago.
That's right. This team's believing. And, you know, Oregon, they haven't been stopped either on offense, but they've got some holes defensively.
Well, a 7-6-8 winning percentage since 2010. 53-16 since then. North Dakota State at the top of the heap, and then Barber at 43-7 in the FCS since 2010. Here's an onside kick. It is gathered in by the hands team, the upbacks. That time Oregon, I think, was wise to it. They were ready for something.
Well, here's the strategy. If you're Bo Baldwin right now, you're kind of trading scores. You know that you have not been able to stop Oregon really defensively. They haven't necessarily been able to stop you. So you got to hope you can create a couple turnovers, some explosive plays, because upsets do happen. We've seen them in college football. Don't turn the channel, Ken.
No, absolutely not. Eastern Washington beat number 25 Oregon State 49-46 back in 13, as you mentioned, with Vernon Adams scoring four touchdowns through the air and then running for two himself. Vernon Adams is in at quarterback and hands to Royce Freeman. He bounces out to the far side, missed tackle, gets across for the first down, and then is driven out of bounds inside the 35-yard line.
You know, the great thing for Oregon is that they have the motto, win the day, right? They just go to their next play. That's what they do. That's who they are. But they've also had the ability to talk to Vernon Adams about his former team, and I'm sure the first thing he said is they do not quit, so we're going to have to play a complete game.
First down, just under 2 minutes remaining in the third.
See him slowing the tempo up.
Make it second and two. Adams will run. He's got the first down. He's across the 30-yard line.
Really nice job, design run here. Quarterback draw, drops. Remember, this offensive line, pretty impressive. Matt Hegarty, I haven't talked enough about him at the center position. Transfer, graduate transfer from Notre Dame.
Adams has now run the ball 12 times for 89 yards. Tony Brooks James is in the backfield. He is called upon to carry it, and he will. He'll take three tacklers with him across the 20-yard line and very close to a first down.
You think of Oregon, you think of the swoosh, you think of the multiple uniforms, but they're a downhill running team, and they've got to be good up front. Matt Pearson, the left guard, Cameron Hunt, right guard, done a nice job inside.
Screen pass, left side, Addison with it. He's across the 10, and they got chopped down very close to a first down.
But sometimes when these skill position players don't get the ball, they just kind of hit that X button. You know, all of a sudden, there they go.
Second down. And a beautiful tackle applied there. As Tony Brooks James tried to accelerate. Cole Karstetter, though, met him at the ankles and chopped him down.
Cole Karstetter, remember, his brother, Jared Karstetter, played at Washington State. Another brother playing at Idaho State.
Adam drops the ball, but it looks like the back, Tony Brooks James, was able to jump on it. And so Oregon will have possession with 34 seconds remaining here in the third, but it brings up a fourth down, and it looks like that Mark Helfrich will elect to kick here.
Man, you got to make that catch if you're going down. This is what you do at the quarterback position. He knows it. You're going to get a bad snap or not a perfect snap. That was by no stretch a bad one, but and rotate your hands underneath the football on a low snap, just like a receiver should on a low throw.
H. Steiner is out there with a 30-yarder in his sights. Right between the hash marks, they'll set up. The snap, the hold, the kick is up, it is good. That will end the third quarter of play. This fourth quarter ought to be a doozy. There are a whole lot of storylines going in this one. At Autzen Stadium in Eugene, the Ducks right now lead the Eagles of Eastern Washington 54-35 here on the Pac-12 Network. You, Mike, Yogi Roth, Kevin Calabro, Lewis Johnson on the scene here at Autzen Stadium. Number 7, Oregon, outscoring Eastern Washington 17-14 in the third. And a 54-35 score, Oregon leading. We head to the fourth quarter of play. Eastern Washington without their starting quarterback, Jordan West, out with cramps in the lower right leg. And his understudy, Riley Hennessy, has come on to lead Eastern to a couple of touchdowns in the third quarter. Eastern will get the ball back on the return. They'll start things at about the 19-yard line. Let's take a look now at the Red Vines' sweet moment.
Well, it's sweet moments of the game because it's Cooper Kupp, baby. He not only got married in the offseason, but he also worked on his game. And he's been making plays all evening long. 10 grabs, 198 yards, 2 touchdowns. And he's been an absolute beast. I mean, really just dominant against these young corners of Oregon in every phase, whether it's been press coverage, he's been patient on the line of scrimmage, big plays down the field. With two quarterbacks, he has literally willed this team into this ballgame.
Man from Yakima with 198 yards, as Yogi mentioned, he had 197 career catches coming into tonight's game. That is 6th all-time at Eastern Washington. And he is just a junior playing in his first game of the year. Riley Hennessy, redshirt freshman, going to work. Settles into the pocket, he is poised, and he spots his man, Cooper Kupp, coming open across the middle for the first down.
You know, it's impressive right there as Oregon completely shifted. They just rushed 3 defenders. They dropped 8 just to try to make Hennessy beat him with his arm. See a lot of Oregon jerseys.
Hennessy unloads to the man coming out of the backfield. That is complete.
And check out the previous play. Only 3 defenders are going to rush for Oregon. They're going to drop 8 into coverage. Make it hard on Hennessy. That's what you do on a young quarterback. Try to make the window small. He continues to go through his progression. I'm telling you, big time credit to Bo Baldwin, his coach, really teaching him the nuances of this position to step in and play like he has.
Malcolm Williams Jr. made the catch a moment ago. Turns up field, leans ahead. He's very close to a first down. Mm-hmm.
I'm continually feeding Cooper Kupp. 211 yards now, career high for the junior receiver. Fireworks going on. Pull out the hashtag, baby. Pac-12 after dark. Let's roll.
Somebody got a little itchy with the fireworks, I guess. This thing is not over. Hennessy steps up in the pocket and throws a bullet, rifling it about a foot and a half off the turf, where only his receiver could get down there and slide and make the catch. Beautifully thrown ball.
Well, they're trying to double team. It's called bracket coverage. That means you put one defender on the inside, one on the outside of Cooper Kupp. Not the easiest thing to beat, but a really nice job by Cooper Kupp running his route.
Yogi, 12 receptions for Kupp. That ties his career high. They give it to Williams, the rookie. The freshman has had some nice carries here in this second half of play. He is from Fresno, California. Good-looking young athlete.
I'll be honest, defense looks a little tired right now.
And Eastern Washington, they've really done a nice job to rotate guys into that backfield. Including this man, Riley Hennessy, the quarterback. Steps back and throws over the top. Complete to Kupp, but he dropped the ball.
He runs a little nod route, meaning you attack the inside shoulder of the backer, then try to get over the top. You don't see him drop too many passes. Jawan Williams playing him there. The redshirt sophomore got lucky there for Oregon.
Second and 10. Hennessy avoids the rush. Spots a man angling from the near side. Simba Webster, the freshman from Antioch, California, angles near the first down.
I tell you, when you talk about quarterbacks, you talk about the subtle movements in the pocket. And Hennessy, he's more quick than he is fast. His subtle movements in the pocket, his little jab step, it's really kept the defenders, the defensive front of Oregon, off balance a little bit. It's allowed him a little extra time to make some of these unique throws. And he's a thrower. I mean, that is his skill set. In high school, 64 touchdowns in 2 years. Jordan West watching this go down. He's probably saying, I want to get back out there. I don't want to lose my job.
Well, Mark Helfrich insisting that Eastern had 12 men on the field. Bo Baldwin immediately calls a timeout. Well, there are some big games, of course, facing Pac-12 teams this year. Pac-12 big tickets. How about beginning next weekend when Oregon travels to take on Michigan State, and then Cal goes to Austin to take on Texas, BYU and UCLA at the Rose Bowl on September 19th. And as usual, USC and Notre Dame every year. This year, October the 17th, Notre Dame and Stanford on the 28th.
Well, I'll tell you what, Pac-12 is going to need to win some of those games, yeah, because very disappointing day for the conference for the most part. UW, tough loss last night. Luke Falk, hopefully he's all right, went out with an injury late. Arizona State looks like they're going to lose. Stanford gets upset against Northwestern on the road. But that's the beauty of college football. I mean, you live and die week to week.
Six teams in the Pac-12 ranked in the top 25 when the weekend began.
Offside. Defense number 79. A 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Oregon penalized again. They have been inconsistent. 9 penalties, 75 yards.
False start. Offense, number 79. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Well, they've reversed themselves on the field. I think there was miscommunication there for a moment. They have corrected the call and will go against Eastern Washington. So it brings up third and six for the Eagles. Hennessy was wrapped up but throws to Nick Splendorio over the middle for a first down.
That's an impressive play. You got DeForest Buckner, a perennial first-round pick, All-American, breathing down your neck as a redshirt freshman. I promise you, he has never seen DeForest Buckner type athlete running after him. He just climbs the pocket, gets tackled, completes the pass.
Ducks have been unable to get to the quarterback and inflict any kind of pain. Here is Hennessy floating one out to the far side. That one is intended for Kendrick Bourne. Bourne turned into a defender that time because it looked like Arian Springs actually had a better angle to the ball, and Bourne broke it up.
And Arian Springs, he can run. That's his skill set. You want to go deep on him, that's where he's good. Crowd wanted an offensive PI.
Yeah, I think Bourne just did a nice job, Yogi, to get his hand right in the chest of Springs and throw him off, and the ball was delivered there. Good play.
And they've been battling all night long, this secondary against the receivers.
Second and 10, Hennessy back to throw. Tosses that one right into coverage, and it is intercepted. Juwan Williams, the sophomore from Tucker, Georgia, comes up with the pick. And Hennessy tried to force that one into a crowd, Yogi.
100%. His eyes were on Terry Jackson the entire time. That's a redshirt freshman. That's a big play for that defense. Oregon gaining the moment.
He's like Houdini. He had I feel like if he was at a Division I school when he did that, he would have been up for the Heisman.
One heck of a player. That guy is a very good quarterback and makes a lot of plays.
I mean, he was a great talent. He did some good things at Eastern. You know, and to be honest, I'm excited to see what he does at Oregon.
I was hoping that was the last I had seen of him, but I guess not.
Said he actually got a Facebook message from Shaq Thompson after they played, and it was a couple weeks ago actually before he passed that math class, said you can play in this level in the Pac-12, and he clearly can.
Well, he put 7 touchdowns on Washington when Shaq was playing for the Huskies last year. On first down, they get Kenai Benoit in space, but he is tripped up. Look at Adams' numbers, 19 to 25, 246. A couple of touchdowns, no interceptions. He's been good on the ground. We'll hand off to Benoit, who zigzags his way across the 35-yard line. It'll bring up a third down.
He's done a nice job spreading the ball around. 8 different receivers for Oregon have touched the rock tonight. 5 different players have carried the ball on the ground. Clearly a lot of weapons here for Oregon.
And cramping cost them their starting quarterback, Jordan West, early in the third quarter of play. And now it's afflicted Eastern Washington again. Well, tonight, following the Arkansas State-USC game, stay tuned for Pac-12 final score. Mike Yam, Lincoln Kennedy, and Nigel Burton wrap up the entire day of college football. Pac-12 final score later tonight on Pac-12 Network. Yogi Roth, Kevin Calabro, Lewis Johnson with you tonight here at Autzen Stadium in Eugene, Oregon. It was a good fortune to be in Corvallis last night to see Gary Anderson's first game as the head football coach of the Oregon State Beavers. They successfully beat Weber State and I think answered a question about their quarterback.
Seth Collins, one of a few true freshmen playing quarterback in the Pac-12 conference this weekend. We saw Jake Browning, of course, last night in a tough loss on the road at Boise State. And then today, Josh Rosen, he just went off. And yeah, Kevin, he's as gifted as anybody in this conference throwing the football.
Adams will hand off. And Oregon with a first down. They bring in Royce Freeman. They'll make that Benoit going back to work. So you may see a steady diet of Benoit, Tony Brooks, James. Because Freeman has had a full night of work. 21 carries, 180 yards, 3 touchdowns for Freeman. One shy of tying his career high touchdowns in a ball game. Benoit now will rotate out for a breather. First and 10 with 9:45 to go in the ball game. Adams at 5'10", fakes, runs, slides, got popped, and the ball dislodged. The flags are flying, and Vernon Adams is rolling over on his stomach, not getting himself up. He is wobbling. Oh my! He got popped. He's trying to get his legs under him and having difficulty. The training staff there to attend to him.
After the play, personal foul with targeting, defense number 44, a 15-yard penalty with an automatic first down. The play will be reviewed.
And Eastern has a player down as well.
See Vernon slide. And that's tough. It really is. This is a tough play on a defender. You know the rule. It's late in the game. You're trying to create a turnover. Mm-hmm. When you watch Vernon Adams on film, when he was at Eastern or whether he was here throughout this game, he does a lot of that, sliding at the last second. It's hard on a defender. It's the letter of the law. You cannot lead with the crown of your helmet. It's the proper call for sure.
Mike Evans out of San Francisco studios. Just a reminder, we're going to get you to USC immediately after the Oregon game ends. It has just kicked off. You can begin watching Arkansas State and USC on Pac-12 Los Angeles, Pac-12 Now, or on pac-12.com.
John Crayfield's called for the personal foul on the targeting call as he came in low on Vernon Adams, sliding to the turf. And you're right, Yogi, that's awfully difficult. You want to make an aggressive play. You want to force a turnover.
I mean, that's real time. You're trying to make a play. Vernon slides. I mean, that's the letter of the law. That's exactly what the penalty is supposed to stop. And as a defender, you want to prepare yourself for the quarterback sliding, but it's hard because you're coming full speed, and all of a sudden, your target completely changes his trajectory. And I would not think that John Kreyfuss or anybody in Eastern Washington is trying to be malicious, but you can watch Vernon Adams' helmet slides back, and you're just happy to see him walk off, and hopefully he'll be all right.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Number 44 is disqualified.
So Kreyfuss disqualified, and Vernon Adams Junior going back to the Oregon locker room. I presume his night is done with 9:30 remaining in his ball game, and Oregon leading 54-35. Jeff Lockie now will quarterback the Oregon Ducks.
And for Kreifels, he's going to miss the first half of the next game, but Vernon Adams, they also hope he's all right because they got to go on the road to East Lansing.
Kreifels, the sophomore from Modesto, motioning to the crowd. He should just put his hands down and go to the locker room, and I think that's what Bo Baldwin's telling him. Yeah you know what,
that's not okay, because that signals to us that it was intentional, and that's an embarrassment if that's the truth. And that young man should go to the locker room, and he should be suspended for the next game. And I know Bo Baldwin, that's not what he stands for. That's not what the history of his coaching career, what they do at Eastern Washington, how they've treated the matchup against Vernon Adams. He's been so respectful. The truth about that relationship, they're incredibly friendly. They talk to each other extremely often. It's not made out to what it is in the media in terms of the hatred from one school against Vernon Adams. So, you know, Bo Baldwin hates seeing that more than anyone. That is not the classy effort that his team traditionally showcases. And it's an embarrassment. Too bad for that young man.
Yeah. He didn't need to demonstrate. Just get to the locker room. So Jeff Lockie steps in. Lockie, of course, did the backup duty to Marcus Mariota, the Heisman Trophy winner for the last couple of years. They hand off to Benoit, and he rumbles across for a first down. And Benoit has been effective tonight. 6 feet, 210, sophomore from Phoenix, Arizona.
And for Jeff Lockie, you want to talk to the other side. You want to talk about what class stands for. It's been him. I mean, he easily could have become a locker room lawyer, and all of a sudden could have tried getting people police for him, becoming the starting quarterback. He never once did that. He went to compete. He tried to get the job, got beat out fairly, and he tipped his hat to Vernon Adams and said, I'm just going to keep working, and now he's getting his opportunity in the game.
Handoff comes to Benoit. trying to cut it back, is met by two defenders, and he's knocked down at the 15-yard line. Well, this young fella tonight has 10 carries to his credit, 76 yards and a touchdown.
Remember Oregon, they got three different types of tempos for the most part. Green, yellow, and red. Red is when they kind of look to the sideline, take their time. Their version of a four-minute offense and try to run the football, try to win the football game, take as much time off the clock as you can.
Tony Brooks James in the lineup now in the backfield. Gets a nice block, cuts to the 10, cuts it back in to the end zone on his 2 feet. Touchdown, Oregon. Dwayne Stanford springs him with a block. And the Ducks on the board, 60 big ones, with 7:47 remaining in the ballgame.
Tony Brooks James, he's a scout team, service team player of the year last year. Bided his time, really had a strong training camp. And they're competing for backup reps. Royce Freeman clearly the starter, but Benoit's played well tonight. Brooks James, even true freshman Taj Griffin, we haven't seen him yet. They talked about how well he had played in training camp. All trying to get reps because they need to be fresh for this offense to roll. You got to have multiple running backs.
Aiden Snyder adds the extra point and makes it 61-35 Oregon. 7:47 left in the ballgame from Eugene. Well, the Duck is doing overtime. A lot of points on the board. 61-35 Oregon, 7:47 to go here in the ballgame in this Pac-12 football broadcast presented by Bank of the West. Eastern Washington will get the football back as Simba Webster, the freshman, breaks a tackle or two and is upended across the 30-yard line. Let's check in now with Mike Yam in San Francisco.
Kevin, times for a Transamerica game break. We expected to see a high-scoring affair, specifically points put on the board from the Trojans. Didn't take too long. Cody Kessler, the 61-yard strike to Juju Smith-Schuster. Right now, it's the Trojans rolling 7-0 in the early going. Once again, you can watch this game on Pac-12 Now and Pac-12.com.
Mike, thank you. Riley Hennessy comes back out to quarterback the Eastern Washington Eagles. Hennessy, the redshirt freshman from the state of Washington, Gatorade Player of the Year in Washington in 2013, redshirted last year. Hands off to Williams, another freshman, and he gets across the line of scrimmage and picks up maybe a yard or two on the play.
He's got a big time bright spot.
Yeah,
redshirt freshman, first time he's ever played college football. He didn't flinch. Came in, his first drive, down in the red zone, throws a touchdown pass, scrambled out. He looks like he's a veteran.
Scans right, throws left. Tried to just dump it down, but the ball ricochets off the intended receiver's number, Zach Wimberly. And incomplete. Third and eight. Story for Eastern was Jordan West. He and Cooper Kupp connecting in the first half. Mark Helfrich, the head football coach of Oregon, told Lewis Johnson, we're making Cup look like he's all galaxy. Well, he has been terrific tonight. West went out with cramps early in the third, and this man, Hennessy, has taken over beautifully. He's flushed out of the pocket. Scrambles out near the 50-yard line. He has a first down.
He's fleet of foot, too. He's really athletic. And you know, I see these young high school quarterbacks, and it used to just be the athletes were the athletes and the throwers were the throwers who couldn't run.
Yeah.
Now, over the last 5 years, they're in a complete blend. This is exactly what Riley Hennessy is. He's a unique athlete in terms of his footwork, his initial quicks. He can get away, and all of a sudden, if you want to drop eight, he's going to find the seam. He's going to get a first down, get down, and that's what really can kill defense. So I think in the Big Sky this year, whether he's the quarterback and ideally, Jordan West gets healthy and he's all right after the cramps. They got two guys that can lead them to another championship.
West continues to walk up and down the sidelines. They give it to Williams again, and he is across for the first down on second down.
A
Well, that's pretty much what the Oregon defense does. They don't give you a lot of points, but move the ball down the field against them. That's been their record over the last couple of years.
And I think tonight they're going to wish they created some more turnovers.
Yeah, oh yeah.
You know, they have the opportunities to ball in the other secondary. They're going up against Connor Cook, who I believe is one of the top 5-10 quarterbacks in the country. He's a pro-style quarterback.
Cup makes the catch. Vernon Adams is back. And I think if for no other reason, just to come back out here and see the end of this game with 5:40 remaining.
That's good, too. See him come back smiling.
Hennessy on 2nd and 7. We'll give to the diminutive Jabari Wilson. 5'11", maybe, and 200 pounds. He plows ahead for another first down. You know, the other thing is they didn't get to the quarterback. Just one sack on Jordan West tonight.
Yeah, and they're going to want to put some pressure on Connor Cook next week because he's the type of guy, he's a veteran quarterback, right? Could have left early for the National Football League, decided to return to college. But this is an experienced team, a very physical team.
They again go to the ground. Jabari Wilson is shoestring. Get knocked down, but he picks up 4 on the play.
And I think also, too, to not think too much about this game and even other games around the country. Michigan State, they struggled with Western Michigan. Majority of college teams don't play as well as people think they should play week one. It's the first time you're playing live, the first time you're seeing real fast tempo. But the rules have changed in college football, and even coaches have adjusted. There's not a lot of scrimmages. You scrimmage once, maybe twice in training camp. There are minimal, if any, two-a-days.
Tennessee's flushed. He avoids a tackler and then secures the ball down there at the 25-yard line. Michigan State coming up next week. Number 5, Michigan State beat Western Michigan 37-24 yesterday. Connor Cook, Yogi mentioned, 15-31 in that ball game, 256 with a couple of touchdowns.
I think this schedule, too, Kevin, it really plays out well for Oregon. I mean, Utah, this place is going to be rocking when they play. We all saw what they did against Michigan. But the first half of this season, they have the ability to be undefeated heading into that game at Arizona State. So I think with what happened in the North today with Stanford losing, Oregon's got as good a chance as any to kind of run the table to put themselves in position again to represent the North in the Pac-12 championship game. And that was a big expectation, obviously, coming in as well.
Williams, after the carry, will come out. It's first down for the Eagles, 3:40 remaining in the ballgame. Coming up next, Arkansas State taking on number 8 USC, followed by Pac-12 final score. Beautifully thrown ball. Cooper Kupp leaps into the air, and he draws 9 guys to him down there at the 5-yard line and is still able to stand his ground. Kupp has been magnificent tonight. He now has a career high in receptions. That is 14. And he is over 200 yards down reception, Joe.
And really what I love about him is his physicality. He's so durable. You know, he never really takes a big hit. He plays as physical as any receiver, you know, we've seen. He is a guy who loves the moment. He's got incredible hands. He's a guy you're going to want to follow if you're an Oregon fan all year long. He's going to put up huge numbers. He might end up playing for a while because he's so sure-handed and so crisp in his routes.
Kupp, 14 catches, 239 yards, 2 TDs. And the pass from Hennessy down to the goal line is broken up, intended for Bourne.
You know, for this Oregon defense, what's great about this game is that in the back end, take a look, see if he caught the rock. Yeah, that's a ground. Yeah, that's not close.
That brings up 2nd and goal. And they wait the formation to the left. And they have movement up front, and the flags are flying, and Eastern Washington was skittish there at the line of scrimmage.
False start. Offense, number 92. 5-yard penalty, 2nd down.
That's 11 penalties on Bo Baldwin's Eagles for 82 yards.
And I think for Bo Baldwin, he told us heading into this game, he thought it was one of his most talented teams, if not his most talented team at Eastern Washington. Just the depth they have, the way they've developed, the way they've recruited. They're going to look back at this game. They had their opportunities. They could match score for the most part, but all those penalties ended up hurting him.
Hennessey looking to cut. Beautifully thrown ball to the far corner of the end zone. Touchdown. Third touchdown reception of the evening for Cooper Kupp, who is having a career night against the number 7 Oregon Ducks. And what a beautifully thrown ball that was from Hennessey, right on the number.
Oh, just soft. Wow. The hands above your eyes. That's clinic tape right there. And Bo Baldwin said it. He said, quote, "I'd be shocked if he didn't have a huge game," when we talked to him earlier this week. And I'll be honest, when I heard this, really, in my mind, man, you're going up against some of these athletes, these secondary of Oregon, the front seven is going to get some pressure on you. And he's done it. You know, Cooper Kupp, hats off to you, man. What a game.
Yeah, I thought it would be more pressure on the quarterback, Yogi, but Mark Helfrich said, we're thin in that back line, that back four. We are thin back there. They're playing a lot of young guys tonight who've been tested, but the Ducks still lead 61-42. Well, a fun ball game to watch here at Autzen Stadium in Eugene. 61-42 the count. The Birds going at it here, the Eagles and the Ducks. 2:35 remaining in the ball game. This Pac-12 broadcast is presented by Bank of the West. Vernon Adams, after getting jolted on the field, went back to the locker room. They attended to him. He came back out onto the field. Raylan Addison catches the fluttering kickoff. And Oregon will go back to work. Here's the way Vernon Adams' evening unfolded.
Well, he started off incredibly well. First drive, touchdown, led him all the way down toward the back shoulder, touchdown. Really impressive job, I thought, his command of the offense. Then, unfortunately, takes the what looked like as a cheap shot, especially after he saw the defender, John Kreyfus, walk off the field. But it's good to see him out here. You know, went into the locker room, probably went through all the protocols that the medical staff asked you to go through, and hope he's all right, because you want to see that matchup next week. I mean, this is going to be a matchup the whole country is going to be tuning into. Everybody tuned in tonight to see who Vernon Adams truly was. I think we saw somebody who plays graduate level football, a guy who understands specific situations, and he was in all of them tonight offensively. 2-minute offense, backed up, 4-minute offense, sudden change offense, after an explosive play, after the other team made an explosive play. I thought that if there was one positive to really take away, is that this entire Oregon team, Vernon Adams specifically, had to go through all the situations necessary in live action that you try to create in practice, but it's really hard to create that type of tempo.
And with how many practices, too, Yogi, in preparation, right?
I mean, let's keep in mind.
2.5 weeks?
Yeah, I mean, this is college football history, what we witnessed tonight. I mean, how many times does somebody leave a smaller school to take a shot, to not just go to a bigger school, but one of the top five schools in the country, at the quarterback position, replacing Marcus Mariota, doesn't know the system, doesn't practice with the team until the fifth practice of training camp, no spring, no summer organized workouts, and he wins the job in 2 weeks, and comes out and plays extremely efficiently in his first game.
Well, we're seeing Taj Griffin get some touches now, converted to a running back, 5'10 freshman from Powder Springs, Georgia. He's gotten a couple of touches back there.
He's a great story, too. I mean, he got banged up in high school. You know, when you get injured in high school before your senior year, you're always nervous. Is a team going to pull the scholarship? Mark Helfrich called immediately, said that's not going to happen. His brother's playing DB now here as well, former QB.
Look at him out in the open field. He's gotten into the 50. He tapped at a 20, and he is hauled down inside the 10-yard line. Taj Griffin. He goes 61 yards on that burst. We talked about the embarrassment of riches here in Oregon. They just come in waves.
You think he was sitting on the sideline saying, just give me my chance. He saw Tony Brooks James. He saw Benoit. Obviously, Royce Freeman just wanted his chance. And this is a guy, he's a 4'3", 40 guy. 45-inch vertical leap. I mean, he's a dynamic athlete. Expect to see him now that clearly they burned his redshirt. He's going to get some play as the season goes on.
487 yards on the ground for Oregon. Lockie will take a knee, and that will be that. You know, on top of that, we didn't see Charles Nelson tonight, a highly valued wide receiver. He may have had an injury situation, but we'll look for him possibly next week at Michigan State. Oregon wins this one 61-42. Behind Vernon Adams. The era of Vernon Adams ended at Eastern Washington, and for 1 year it begins tonight here at Oregon.
And it's good to see. Look at the two best friends, Vernon Adams and Cooper Kupp's wedding. These coaches, great respect for one another. Now they've built their programs. All in all, I think tonight's game was great for Oregon. They're going to refocus, especially in the back end, heading to East Lansing, go up against Michigan State a week from now. And for Vernon Adams, they've got their quarterback, Kevin. This young man, I think he's going to be a special player here.
And for Eastern Washington, boy, they're a team that bears watching. They're going to be very exciting there in Cheney, Washington. Cooper Kupp was magnificent tonight. Career highs, receptions, yards, and he had the three touchdowns through the air as well. And they've got a couple of quarterbacks who can get it done.
They really do. All in all, first weekend of college football, Pac-12 after dark. Vernon Adams, tune in. Hopefully he's healthy for next week. It's going to be sweet when they take on the Spartans.
We had a lot of fun doing the double dip here in the state of Oregon in Corvallis last night and Eugene tonight. Yogi Roth, Lewis Johnson, Kevin Calabro, David Feldman, our producer, Thompson Tersky, our director from Eugene. That will do it from here. Again, the Ducks win this one going away. We now take you to L.A. where Ted Robinson, Clint Barker, Jill Savage stand by with a call of Arkansas State and USC.